CBS. Buffalo has won the toss, and they've elected to receive the football. This series dates back to 1960. The Bills lead the series 51-42. They met earlier this year on September 30th in Buffalo. Bills winning that game 17-14. Trent Edwards with a terrific performance in his first start for the Buffalo Bills. Jets and Bills were underway from the Meadowlands, and this is McGee winging it out of his own end zone. Terrence McGee over the 20, and he gets up to the 24-yard line before being stopped. Brad Smith with the tackle, and that's a return of 26 yards. So Trent Edwards last week against Baltimore, 11 of 21, a buck 53, one interception. 98 of his 153 passing yards went to Lee Evans. This young man is from Los Gatos, California, right outside of Stanford, where he graduated from college. Very bright person. Majored in political science, 3.0 grade point average, and he has a 3 handicap.
Yeah, he can hit the golf ball, I know, and I think the thing that sets him apart, Gus, is his ability to communicate. The team really rallies around him.
First down and 10. Here's Marshawn Lynch running it over the right side. He'll push the pile forward and get to the 30-yard line. So let's take a look at the Bills offensively. Jason Peters was an undrafted tight end out of Arkansas, and he's become one of the most talented left tackles in all of football. The backs and receivers, Marshawn Lynch, 12th overall pick out of Cal, talented running back as well. Last week against Ray Lewis in the Ravens, 27 carries, 84 yards. He has yet to go over the 100-yard mark. He told us yesterday he feels that today is his day to do it against these Jets. Second and 4 at the 30. And they run it straight ahead again. Not a lot of room over that left side. Beautiful tackle by Abram Elam, and it's a gain of 1 yard. Defensively for the Jets, they've had some problems getting pressure on the quarterback. Sean Ellis leads this team in sacks. He only has 2, Robertson and Coleman as well. The linebackers, Jonathan Vilma, out for the season with a knee injury, so David Harris, the impressive rookie out of Michigan, second-round pick, replaces him. He'll make all the calls. And in the secondary, Hank Poteet, back-to-back interceptions last couple of weeks against Donovan McNabb and last week against the Cincinnati Bengals, Carson Palmer, and he plays the right corner spot. Third down and 3 at the 31. Jackson lines up in the backfield. Edwards in the shotgun. Fires to the far side. Caught. Looks like a first down. Josh Reed with the reception on the far side in front of David Barrett, and that's a gain of 5.
And we spoke to a lot of Jet players, and you talk about this Bills offense, and Trent Edwards has, you know, his focal point, but the 3 wide receivers, Josh Reed, Lee Evans, and Roscoe Parrish, are all completely different. Josh Reed is a strong inside over the middle receiver. Lee Evans, elite, fast on the outside, and Roscoe Parrish is a dangerous punt returner who they stick in there sometimes. All 3 very different.
So a first down for Buffalo at the 35. Here's Marshawn Lynch trying to set up his block, and he'll get to the 38-yard line before being stopped. Ryan Thomas, first man to him, and that's a gain of 4. And how about Marshawn Lynch, Steve? You were a 7-time Pro Bowler with the Buffalo Bills. You still live in the Buffalo area, and they're really excited about this young man.
Well, he's played a lot, and he's played very well. They've really been excited about his potential. He's not there yet. He needs to do some things in his game. He'll tell you he needs to learn how to pass protect first. You know, it's really difficult. That's the most important thing he has to learn. Everything else, of course, is instinct.
Second down and 6 at the 39. Here's Lynch again over the left side. And Lynch gets up to the 45-yard line. Eric Barton with the tackle. What makes Marshawn Lynch such a dangerous player is not only can he run inside, he can get it outside and catch the ball out of the backfield.
He really is, and he's a great guy to talk to. He's really, really meshed with this club well. They've really embraced him as their number one guy, and he's a personality. We spoke to him last week, and you see here running against Baltimore. He was like a wide-eyed kid playing against Ray Lewis and the stars in the NFL. He's still got that naivete about him, you know.
Third down and 1 at the 45. And they'll go straight ahead looking for the first down. And it looks like the Bills have it.
Did I say that right, naivete? I don't know, but he's
got... You know what, you're from Kansas. You can say it that way if you want to.
Thank you. But you see, as they do the quarterback sneak there and get the first down, and this is something that the Bills, I think, have really done well at this year, being able to stay on the football field. They've gotten some criticism for not throwing the football down the field very much, either with J.P. Lossman or Trent Edwards, but they have been able to move the football, but not very many touchdowns.
Dwayne Wright has checked in for Buffalo. He's in the backfield. Reed in motion on first down. Here's Wright, stutter step. And he goes down at about the 48-yard line. 3-yard pickup. So the Buffalo Bills, no secret what they want to do to start this game, Steve. They are attacking this Jet team that's had a problem this season stopping the run.
Well, and you can't see it maybe on your television set, but this, it's very windy right at midfield, right where they're at. They're not going to throw the football into the wind. The Bills are going straight into a face wind. It's about 15 miles per hour right at field level. It was blowing that way a couple of minutes before kickoff, and I think that's one reason they're not throwing it around a little bit.
Second down and 7 at the 49. Edwards in the shotgun. We'll let this one fly down the sideline. Caught out of bounds. Lee Evans at the 35. Terrific looking grab. It's a gain of 16 in front of Dyson. So let's set up the weather for you. 61 degrees with an 18 to 20 mile per hour wind.
Yeah, it's a great day except for that wind, and that's going to wreak havoc mostly in the kicking team. And this is the flag, the color guard, the flags the color guards had, and that those flags blowing there, they're blowing just about from right to left on your television screen. That's the direction the wind's going, and it's right at field level.
Ninth play of the drive that started at the Buffalo 24. First down at the 35. Play action. Edwards sets up a screen. He's got his man. This is Robert Royal, the tight end, and Royal is wrapped up and taken down, but he picks up 9 yards on the play.
And the Jets think they got a fumble, and the officials are not having any of it. They're just marking the ball. But this is the kind of drive early on. This is what the Buffalo Bills have gotten with Trent Edwards. A very steady, not spectacular drive, but it's almost boring to watch. Short passes, hard runs, tough, hard-nosed football, just hanging on to the football, not turning it over, and moving it down the field. The question is, can they get more than 3 points out of it?
Edwards starts the game 3 of 3, 29 yards, second down and short. They need a yard. Here's Lynch. Leans forward. And he's close to the first down. And Marshawn Lynch, already in his career as a professional, has that unique ability to always fall forward, kind of like Rudy Johnson with the Cincinnati Bengals when he gets hit.
Yeah, he really has the ability to find a crease, always run downhill. He always finishes runs. And I think that's what you're talking about. They call that finishing runs, where they just deliver the blow at the end, get that every little yard that's coming to them, and don't leave anything behind on any play. Never take anything for granted, and he already seems to have that knack.
Opening drive for the Buffalo Bills. First down at the New York Jets 24-yard line. Play fake again. Edwards, quick fire, finds Lee Evans. He breaks a tackle, gets inside the 20-yard line. Sean Ellis brings him down from behind. Make that Josh Reed with the reception, and that's a gain of 5.
And the Bills run a lot of those quick screens, hoping, of course, to get a big gain out of a short pass. And these are those 10-plus play drives. The Bills, and this is the Jets allowing it. They've allowed 16 total all year, and the Bills have allowed 14. So both these defenses are that proverbial bend but don't break defense. And we're seeing evidence of that on this first possession.
Second down at 4 at the 18. Here's Wright straight ahead again. He's wrapped up by Eric Barton, but this Buffalo offensive line is having no problem with this Jets defensive line. They are getting a great push.
Well, they're big. I mean, these guys are enormous. Dockery, Peters, Butler.
Langston Walker, the right tackle.
These guys are enormous. Even at NFL standards, this is a big, big offensive line.
66 and 68, that's Dockery. He comes over as an unrestricted free agent from Washington. Langston Walker, an unrestricted free agent from Oakland, to go along with Peters, their left tackle. First and 10 at the 13. 13th play of the drive. They've had it for 7:37. And they run it again. Right. This time, he goes nowhere. David Harris, second round pick, 47th overall out of Michigan, makes the tackle.
Now this play comes to the outside. It looked as though there was a big gap inside right to his left, but he brought it to the outside. Two defenders right there waiting on him, and that's a great defensive play by the Jets. Stunted right into it, right to the point of attack, and there was nobody there to block him. That's what a defense is supposed to look like. At least one free hitter right where the ball is going.
Second down and 10 of the 13. Marshawn Lynch, the deep man, out of the eye formation. Here's Lynch. stumbling. And he'll fall forward and get to the 10. And it's a gain of three. Castle in with the tackle.
I don't think it's any coincidence, too, as the Bills methodically march down the football field. Now they get down inside the 20, and all of a sudden they're looking at their first third and eight. It's always been third and two, third and three, third and one. Now all of a sudden it's third and eight when they get down close. They just are not as effective on first and second down inside the 20-yard line.
10 rushing attempts by the Buffalo Bills on third down and eight. 22 checks in. Freddie Jackson, he's standing right next to Edwards in the shotgun. Four receiver package. Here's the shovel pass. Jackson goes nowhere. Terrific job by Sean Ellis as he jumps on his back, and here comes the field goal unit for the Buffalo Bills.
And that was a little shovel pass attempt. You were right, and the Jets were all over. And I think the Bills have been snake bit in the last few weeks before their bye in the Dallas game when he threw a red zone interception. And, of course, we saw in the open last week where they threw an interception in their own end that went back for a touchdown that cut into their lead. They're really playing it close to the vest. I think it's a smart move here on the road with a young quarterback.
Brings in Ryan Lindell, 7 of 9 on the season, to attempt the 30-yarder. It's up and good. So the Bills march it down the field, have to settle for a field goal. First quarter, they take a 3-0 lead.
You have been assigned middle, seat 34E.
Can I get an aisle seat?
No, Mr. High Maintenance. You may not have an aisle seat.
There are no other...
No.
There are no
seat.
There are no... Well, how about a window?
How about no?
But I was told...
I'm sorry, but I think you have me confused with an airline that cares.
Want more freedom to sit where you like?
Next.
Fly Southwest Airlines and experience the freedom of open seating.
You are now free to move about the country.
Okay, the presentation's tomorrow, so let's make sure we all know our usual responsibilities. Jeff, you keep feeding me old information. Dean, I need you to continue not living up to your resume. Sue, you're in charge of waffling.
Are you sure?
Jerome, you'll talk a big game, then do nothing.
Let's do it.
Rick, can you fold under pressure for me?
Like a lawn chair.
And Ted, you just keep thinking everyone's out to get you.
They are.
I'll be at FedEx Kinko's, where they'll help me design, print, copy, and finish the proposal.
Put your presentations together at FedEx Kinko's, where color copies are now just 49 cents. Our office is your office.
Awesome home theater, Coach.
You bet it is, John. Circuit City's the only place for high def.
What's that?
Fantasy scores. Hey, Circuit City's got FireDog. FireDog does it all. Home theater installs, wireless network, everything.
Then why aren't we your place?
Wife's a favor, we're in the new carpet.
For home theater installation, PC services, and more, ask for FireDog, only at Circuit City.
Pass the ribs, John.
Charlie's gonna want to see this.
No, he's not.
2 and a Half Men. Do you have any idea how much trouble you're in?
I do not.
Then,
how do I look?
Like the love child of Siegfried and Roy.
Don't miss a new episode.
You should have seen the look on your face.
How would you know? You don't look in my face.
Rules of Engagement after a new 2 and a Half Men tomorrow.
You see here the what we're talking about. For the season, up until that point, the Bills had only scored 5 offensive touchdowns on the year, and that is not a graphic that you want your team at the top of.
You take a look at Trent Edwards. Scoring touchdowns has been a problem for this Buffalo squad. However, they will take the 3 points. And look at the time of possession. Yeah. Opening drive, you eat up 10 minutes. That has to be a very positive thing for your offense.
It is a positive. I mean, you look for all that stuff, and when you've got a rookie quarterback, you know that when you get in the red zone, it's going to be more difficult to score, and hopefully they think they can turn the corner at some point.
So Buffalo sends it away. Here's Leon Washington. He will not get a chance. Brad Smith picks it up, the up back, and he goes down at the 10-yard line. John Wendling with the special teams tackle. Here comes Chad Pennington. Big game for him. Could be his last as a starter if he doesn't do something quickly.
The Ford F-150 is equipped with vented disc brakes, standard on all four wheels. They're vented so they stay cooler, perform better, and maximize stopping power. So even though you'll probably never have to haul a 30,000-pound aircraft, at least you know you can stop one.
Stay tight in the pocket. Be on time. Is he blitzing?
3 seconds until sack.
Work your eyes to the left. Stare down that safety.
Off the mic.
What's the corner doing?
Little FC or left?
2 seconds until
this.
Sack.
We need this one.
Looking for Harrison. Harrison's completely covered.
1 second until sack.
Who's breaking through? Who's breaking hot? Who's going hot?
Clark.
As soon as Manning thinks it, then you see it. Highlights, updates, and scores at the speed of light. This is the NFL at sprint speed.
We must stop inflation. Senator, how is that achievable?
More than just fries. I can choose whatever celebrity's nose I want, but I have to have fries with my combo. What about a baked potato? Chili. A side salad. More than just fries. This is America, people.
He's making more sense than the governor.
At Wendy's, you can have more than just fries with your combo, like a side salad, baked potato, or even chili at no extra cost.
That's right.
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by Southwest Airlines. With Southwest Airlines' convenient nonstop flights, it's like having your own company plane. Sprint, proud sponsors and avid fans of the NFL. And by the Ford F-150, built Ford tough.
And welcome back to the Meadowlands. 3-0 Buffalo with the lead. The Jets take over as Chad Pennington under center. Thomas Jones is running back. And they give it to Jones. Jones gets to the 15. Great running room all the way up to the 17-yard line. Kelsey with the tackle. It's a gain of 4. So Chad Pennington, take a look at his numbers this season. Last week against Cincinnati, put up terrific numbers. 20 of 31, 272, 3 touchdowns. And an interception, and they're going to use the hurry-up offense.
Yeah, they're going no huddle here, just as a change of pace, and it's something they haven't shown very much of.
Second down and 5. At the 18-yard line, Jones the single setback. Smith in motion. Play fake. Pennington over the middle. Smith with the grab at the 30-yard line, and he has a first down. A gain of 12. Let's quickly take a look at the lineups for you. DeBrickashaw Ferguson, left tackle, fourth overall pick in 2006. He protects Pennington's backside. The backs and receivers, how about Lavernous Coles last week against Cincy? 8 catches, a 133, 2 touchdowns. First down and 10. Jets at the 30. Pennington with time, steps up, on the move, Pennington lost the ball, loose,
and the Jets,
Jets have it.
Pennington scrambled, and when he goes feet first and gives himself up, he's usually off limits, but that ball popped out of there when he tried to, I think, tuck it away. Great time by the offensive. It's a coverage scramble. He's got all kinds of time. Now watch here. See there, that was a forced fumble by Schobel and almost scooped up by Whitner, but under that stack, the Jets come up with it.
So the Jets catch a break, second down and 3 at the 37-yard line. Now Pennington audibling at the line of scrimmage. Moves into the shotgun. Now back up under center. Jones. No room, and he goes down at the 35. That's a loss of 2 on the play. Defensively, let's quickly take a look at this Buffalo Bills defense. Aaron Schobel has 47 sacks since 2003. He's off to a slow start this year, only a sack and a half. The linebackers, Angelo Crowell, leads them in tackles this season. He is their veteran linebacker. And in the secondary, Terrence McGee is a terrific football player. He's on one side, and Jabari Greer is the corner on the other side. Third down and 5 at the 35. And we have a flag.
That's going to be a neutral zone infraction.
Neutral zone infraction. Defense, number 93. 5-yard penalty results in a first down.
It's Anthony Hargrove. And his coach with some that's not so kind words for him.
Bill Kohler, and I'll tell you, that's a long walk to the sideline knowing you're going to get an earful. And that is a mistake that costs the Buffalo Bills a chance to get the Jets off the field. That's a big penalty.
Jets pick up a first down. They pitch it. Jones. with a seam. And Jones gets to midfield. When we had an opportunity to speak with the Jets, they clearly said that they're going to run the football today.
Yeah, they really want to run the football. They know that the Buffalo Bills team is built to run and pursue. It's a speed defense, not a physical defense. And one thing they complimented the Bills on was their ability to have 10 or 11 guys on the ball at the end of every play. They really pursued. But the Jets really felt like they could get some physical work done up front in the run game.
Thomas Jones with two 100-yard games on the season. Leon Washington checks into the backfield now, standing right next to Chad Pennington. Second down and one after the 9-yard pickup. Inside handoff, Leon Washington, the scat back. Oh! Washington making people miss. Gets it inside the 35. Crowell with the tackle, and it's a gain of 17.
Well, they finally get lined up. Leon Washington's moving around. He didn't know exactly where he was going to be. Watch here. He's a little confused in the backfield, but he's going to take this and bounce up right through into this traffic area. And what happens is the defense starts to pursue up, and he just cuts it back right against the grain, right up inside. One cut, and he was gone.
First down at the 34. Opening drive for the Jets. On the Bills' opening drive, they held the ball for 10 minutes, and they ended up with a field goal. Jones spinning, and he goes down. John DiGiorgio with the tackle, and all of a sudden, Steve, we're already at the end of the first quarter with the score Buffalo 3, the Jets nothing. New York threatening. At the end of the first
quarter. The Ford F-150 has massive lower front control arms and rear shock absorbers mounted outside the frame rails, giving it the highest available payload in its class. Giving you unbelievable handling and control. Now that's forward thinking.
Longer, leaner, sleeker. Step up to exceptional taste that's never filling. Budweiser Select in a new slim can. Slim is in.
Introducing the Chase Freedom Credit Card, now with triple rewards where you spend the most. So if it's gas stations and coffee shops 1 month, and the next month it's grocery stores, the gym, and department stores, Chase Freedom is the only credit card that adjusts as your everyday spending changes and gives you triple bonus rewards automatically. That's Chase Freedom. Get it free at chase.com/freedom.
And welcome back. Tomorrow on CBS, Halloween gets off to a big bang when these super geniuses dress up for a Brains versus Brawn showdown. Don't miss a new Big Bang Theory tomorrow at 8:30, 7:30 Central on CBS. The Bills' first drive, 16 plays, 64 yards. They held it for 10 minutes. The Jets are still on their first drive, 7 plays, 56 yards, and they've had it for 4:53.
Nice little 21-minute first quarter in real time. That's unbelievable.
Second down at 7 at the 31. Leon Johnson. Make that Leon Washington, excuse me, in the backfield. Baker in motion. The pitch. Washington with a block. Turns a corner, still on his feet, and he's knocked out of bounds by DiGiorgio.
Both these
after
clubs
a gain of four.
Excuse me, guys. Both these clubs running the ball very well in the early going. Jets caught a couple of good breaks on this drive. One, the offsides on third and five by the Bills that set them up for the first down, and then getting the punt, the fumble by Pennington back after the scramble. And the Jets trying to make the most of it.
Thomas Jones checks in. Third down, 3 at the 27. Important play for both teams. Here's Pennington, short drop. Fires to the sideline, and it's caught. Patchery picks up the first down. Whitner with the tackle, and it's a gain of five on third down and three.
And that's a Chad Pennington play right there. He got it going. He snapped the ball at the perfect time to give Cotchery leverage on Whitner. And there's no way from the shift that they made that Whitner could get across and make that play on an out route like that, and Pennington knew it.
Dick Duran had some really kind words about Chad Pennington. He said Chad has been criticized, but he's a good field general. He knows what you want to do, and he knows how to attack it. 10th play of the drive that started at the 13-yard line. First and 10 at the 22. Here's Jones skipping, and he hops inside the 20. Wrapped up on the play by John DeGiorgio after a gain of four.
And as we said, both these clubs are notorious for allowing double-digit drives. They've got a lot of drives under their belt that they've given up to other teams of, like, more than 11 plays. Offensive coordinator
is Brian Schottenheimer
for the Jets, doing an excellent job in the run game, mixing it up and letting Chad Pennington run the no huddle.
Second down and six. Here's Pennington over the middle, and it's caught. Cotchery again. DeGiorgio with the tackle. But Jericho Cotchery came into this game with 41 catches in his first meeting against Buffalo. Eight catches, 107.
And you talk about this offense, and Brian Schottenheimer, that's the guy who's calling the plays, and really gets along well with Pennington. I think, you know, there's always, and we talked to Eric Mangini, he said, yeah, there's throws Pennington would like to have back, but he's played a lot of really good football. I think everybody on this Jet team has a lot of faith in number 10.
First down at the 11. Pennington steps back in trouble, and he's written down. Great pressure. Kyle Williams, second-year player out of LSU, with the sack.
Yeah, and this was a double move on the outside. Watch as Pennington's going to pump fake and then go back to the corner, and he just can't. Williams got there too fast. Pennington had Cotchery at the bottom of the field right there. He's going to pump it and then throw to the corner. The play was covered. Pennington tried to roll out, and it just wasn't there. Williams was all over him.
Loss of eight. 18th sack given up by the Jets this year. Second and 18 at the 19-yard line. Chris Baker in motion, the tight end. Here's Pennington. Dumps it off. Jones. And he's wrapped up at the 15. DeGiorgio covering ground once again. Also in on the play, Jabari Greer, a gain of four.
And both these clubs looking like the other. They had gave up long, methodical drives, did their defense. They get down inside the 20, and all of a sudden, things change. Now it's a third and 14 by the Jets, who haven't faced more than a third and five in the entire drive.
Jets need to get to the 1 yard line. Pennington in the shotgun. Smith, the receiver, at the bottom of your screen. Cotchery's in the slot. Lavernous Coles at the top of your screen. Here's Pennington looking. Fires out of the backfield, Jones. And he's wrapped up inside the 10. And the Jets will have to settle for a field goal.
And that's exactly what the Buffalo Bills defense wanted. They dropped completely off, rushed four guys, dropped seven into coverage, and left the short guys completely open, covered the deep ones, and then tried to come up and make the tackle short of the first down. Third and 14, yeah, you can get away with this, and that's what a lot of defenses do. They know they're in field goal range, just make sure they don't get a touchdown.
Brings on Mike Nugent, who's made his last five, this one from 27 yards away. Ben Graham is his holder. Lean snap, up, and good. 10:29 to play, second quarter. We're tied up. Three apiece, Buffalo, New York Jets from the Meadowlands.
It's endless shrimp. The only time of year to enjoy all the irresistible shrimp you can eat. All of your favorites are back, plus new buffalo shrimp. It's endless shrimp for a short time at Red Lobster. Come see what's fresh today.
Play artist Smashing Pumpkins.
That's a sick system. Voice activates MP3s, cell phones.
Do that again.
Play artist Tiffany. Play artist Michael Bolton.
Play artist Korn.
MPGs meet MP3s. The new 35 miles per gallon 2008 Ford Focus.
Hey, Dad, I want you to drop me off a block before we get to the theater.
Sure.
You know, it's just because people in that part of town are riding bikes and have hybrids and stuff.
Well, this is a hybrid.
Like a hybrid hybrid?
I don't know what a hybrid hybrid is, but yes.
Why didn't you ever talk about that before?
Well, never thought I needed to talk about it.
The 34 miles per gallon 2008 Ford Escape Hybrid, the most fuel-efficient SUV on Earth.
It's endless shrimp. The only time of year to enjoy all the irresistible shrimp you can eat. All of your favorites are back, plus new buffalo shrimp. It's endless shrimp for a short time at Red Lobster. Come see what's fresh today.
You're watching the NFL on CBS. The NFL on CBS is sponsored by Chase Freedom, the credit card that lets you switch between cash back and points. And by Red Lobster. Come see what's fresh today during Endless Shrimp at Red Lobster.
Fans, don't forget you can follow all of today's NFL action with live scoring game centers. And for more coverage on the games, don't miss the exclusive game recaps from the booth tonight at CBSSports.com. Three apiece, Jets and the Bills. As the Jets send it away, Terrence McGee back deep. And he'll start from about the 13-yard line. Gets to the 30. And he breaks a tackle, crawls forward. Buffalo will have terrific field position, a 24-yard return. David Bowens with the tackle on special teams.
Doctor about Viagra, America's most prescribed treatment for erectile dysfunction. Learn more at Viagra.com. Ask your doctor if your heart is healthy enough for sex. Don't take Viagra if you take nitrates for chest pain, as it may cause an unsafe drop in blood pressure. Side effects may include headache, flushing, upset stomach, and abnormal vision. To avoid long-term injury, seek immediate medical help for an erection lasting more than 4 hours. Stop taking Viagra and call your doctor right away if you experience a sudden decrease in vision or hearing.
So, 12 o'clock tea time, someone rear-ends us. Day's shot, right? Except I just switched to Progressive Direct Online. They gave me a couple of competitive prices. I picked Progressive and saved $400 a year. And I've been trying to tell these guys I also get their concierge service. So I drop off my car, pick up a rental, and we're gone. So I saved $400 and our tea time. Fantastic.
Progressive Direct. It's about you. And it's about time. Sign up online and save $50.
Wednesday.
What the hell?
That's me.
Now you see them.
She is missing.
Now you don't.
Removing his victim's faces gives him power.
New criminal minds, then.
The house is possessed by evil spirits.
You're caught between the living and the dead.
A new CSI New York after Criminal Minds, CBS Wednesday.
And welcome back. First down and 10 at the 39-yard line for Buffalo. Trent Edwards, 5 of 5, 34 yards. Play fake. Edwards sets up deep in the pocket with time. And this one caught near the sideline. Lee Evans going up high to get it in front of Darrell Revis, and it's a gain of 14.
Yeah, and this is a lot of time. Play action gives them this, and all the plays that they ran the ball on that first drive set this up, and their ability to fake that run, and the defense was caught flat-footed, enabling Evans to get down the field and take a long time and then find himself open.
Makes it first down at the 47. They hand it off, Marshawn Lynch, straight ahead. And he'll get inside the 45. Eric Martin, first man to him. And he gains 3 yards on the play. But Steve, this game is flying by. Neither quarterback has thrown an incomplete pass, and the clock has only stopped one time because of an offside penalty defensively against Buffalo.
That's right. It's been like a little 9-year-old game where it's with a running clock where they got to get off the field for the next game.
Second down and 7 at the 44. Dwayne Wright checks in. Anthony Thomas not playing today for Buffalo. He has an eye injury. Edwards again to the sideline, and he throws a strike. This time it's Roscoe Parrish, 22nd catch of the year, and that's a gain of 12.
And this is the kind of throw that you got to make, and Roscoe Parrish is so fast. You see there, Poteet trying to stay with him, knows that he's got to guard the deep ball, and when Parrish, and that's why a guy gets open, Gus, if it's not how fast you run, it's how hard you can stop. And Roscoe Parrish only weighs about 60, doesn't have that much weight to stop.
Edwards has found his rhythm early. He's 7 of 7, 60 yards. They hand it off right. And right in for Anthony Thomas today, wrapped up by Bowens. And it's a loss of one.
And that's the kind of first down play the Jets need, particularly out here. They're just barely inside field goal range, although they do have the wind at their back. But this is a defense now that's starting to get nicked on the outside in the running game after giving up a huge drive on the first possession by the Bills. Now the Bills come out throwing the football deep down the sidelines and trying keeping the Jets off balance.
Second down and 11. Here's Edwards in the gun. Under pressure, and he is dropped. Darrell Revis blitzing. And that time they got some pressure on Edwards. And that will bring up third down and 11.
Yeah, he's going to hit his hot receiver, but you'll see there coming off the corner, Revis hits him. He gets rid of the football, but that's exactly the way a blitz is supposed to work. Make the quarterback throw it before he wants to, and you alert the guys who are blocked that they're not going to have time to penetrate. So if you get picked up by somebody, get your hands up and knock the pass down because it's coming out quick.
Brings up third down and 11 at the 33. Here's Edwards. They bring everybody. Edwards lets it go. Picked off. Revis, the rookie. Up the sideline. And he's down at the 40. Darrell Revis, first interception as a member of the New York Jets.
And that was a rookie interception. The Jets did not line up in a defense. Trent Edwards couldn't sort it out and threw it to the one guy that was double covered.
Super handling all-wheel drive. It's the most thrilling way to carve a corner. And it's only from Acura. Acura. Advance.
See your Acura dealer for attractive lease rates on 2008 Acura models for well-qualified customers.
Dad, tell me a story.
Okay. Once upon a time, there was a prince who rode off to rescue a princess from a dragon. Then he ran into an ogre with three heads. And then everything went kablooey. A turtle army emerged from a valley of ice cream and did battle with a witch's vacuum cleaner who sucked up...
Things can get complicated, but when it comes to your money, ING is making it easier.
So a prince rescued a princess?
Yeah, pretty much.
See why it's easier on the bench. Ask your financial professional about ING. Your future made easier.
One team that's pulled off a three-peat.
But wouldn't it be cool to see...
A four-peat?
Commish.
Ready to witness history, gents? You're drinking it. Every bottle of Miller Lite is 12 ounces of World Beer Cup royalty.
Is that like an Olympiad for beer?
Close, but instead of twirling around in spandex, Miller Lite was dancing its way across some of the most sophisticated palates on the planet.
That's an image.
Here's another. Four golds deep.
I don't know what to say.
You can start with a hearty sippity-doo-dah.
Four-time World Beer Cup gold winner, Miller Lite. Good call.
It's been a wild ride for the Tigers and the Crimson Tide. LSU and Alabama continue the battle to be the best in the SEC West next Saturday on CBS.
A moment ago, intentionally, the Jets never lined up in a regular defensive front. They just milled around, and then when the ball is snapped, then they all come, six guys at once. Edwards tries to get rid of it, just can't get enough on it because of the pressure. He didn't have enough time on the play clock to check out of that play, and I think that's a coaching error, not giving him a chance to do that on a third down.
There's Darrell Revis, 14th overall pick out of Pittsburgh with his first career interception. He's a rookie out of Pittsburgh here with the New York Jets. First down and 10 at the 39. Bennington looks backside, dumps it off. Jones. And Jones wrapped up by Crowell and Jabari Greer. A 9-yard gain.
See, talk about Darrell Revis. He came in on the blitz, almost got it. Well, he did get a nice hit on Edwards, and then on the next play, in the right spot at the right time for the interception. Last week, he was a victim of a couple of pass interference calls, making up for it today.
Second down and one at the 48. Jones with the first down and some. Bounces it outside, turns a corner, and stiff-arms his way out of bounds at the 35. Terrence McGee ushers him out of bounds, but it's a gain of 15. And when Thomas Jones gets an opportunity to find his rhythm, he is dangerous.
He really is. I like him a lot. He makes great cuts. I like the way he bounces things, sets up blocks, and also when he makes a cut, he comes out at full speed. He doesn't lose his velocity, and he moves up the field. He's always threatening to go right up the field, and that frees his defenses better than anything.
Six carries, 35 yards for Jones. First down at the 37. Lennigan. That one deflected at the line of scrimmage. Somebody from Buffalo got a hand on it. Looks like it may have been Big John McCargo, number 97.
Yeah, I think McCargo's going to come in from the defensive tackle right there, 97. Just a bull rush and throws it right at his hand. This game, I mean, these two teams, you know it's going to be a close game. It was the first time they met, and the Jets have continued to work hard. They haven't got many breaks, but this is a club that really believes they can win football games.
That was the first incompletion for Pennington. He's 6 of 7, 42 yards. Second and 10. Straight drop to the far side, incomplete. That one intended for Justin McCareins in front of Kawaki Thomas and Marshawn Lynch for Buffalo as headed into the locker room. Their rookie running back.
You know, on that play, you get a few scattered boos coming down. They think that Thomas Jones is the weapon that I think the Jets should be using. They want him to hand the football off and get into a little bit more manageable third down. Second and 10, hand the football off to a guy who's really had some success.
Third and 10 at the 37. Lavernous Coles has been quiet. He's on the at the top of your screen. No catches so far. Here's Pennington under pressure, and he's sacked. Crowell drops him at midfield. Second sack of the day for Buffalo, and the Jets will have to punt it away.
Yeah, that was a big sack. He comes in, just sent too many off one side. He slips through. Pennington does a nice job pulling that back down. He couldn't even cock this and get rid of it. If he tries to hit somebody, it might be picked off. That's a gotcha play by the Bills defense. They got an untouched player right on the back on quarterback.
A loss of 10. Graham punting from the 39. Roscoe Parrish back deep, end over end. Aussie punt, fielded at the 9-yard line, and Parrish crosses the 15. Bowens grabs him again. A 38-yard punt and an 8-yard return. Buffalo with pressure. Back to the Meadowlands after this. We're tied at 3.
Introducing the all-new ultra-low emission Accord from the most fuel-efficient car maker in America. Because making the perfect car isn't just about the road, but rather everything beyond it. The all-new ultra-low emission Accord from Honda.
Think about it, Frank. Hold on. I'm a salesman. I work in Virginia, but I do business in Colorado.
The bucket's jammed.
It's a hydraulic issue.
Sacramento.
Roger that, 7-9-er. Roger that, 7-9-er.
Fly me in a little lower.
Request permission for lower altitude radio.
Flagstaff.
This is not the democracy, people.
In San Antonio. So I need a network that works where I live. A place called Virgicolamento Flag Antonio. Frank, I'm back.
The new AT&T works in more places like Virgicolamento Flag Antonio.
Information, connectivity, worldwide access, innovative technology, and everything to build the global exchange group of the future. The New York Stock Exchange. One market, infinite possibilities.
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by NYSE Euronext. One market, infinite possibilities. Acura. Acura. Advance. And by DirecTV. For the most sports in HD, you have to get DirecTV.
Welcome back. 5:58 to play in the second quarter. Our game is tied at three. The Jets and the Buffalo Bills. Edwards passing on first down. Fires over the middle to Dwayne Wright. And Wright crosses the 25, gets up to the 26, an 8-yard gain. David Harris with the tackle. And if you weren't with us, Marshawn Lynch, a very talented rookie running back out of Cal for Buffalo, has been taken into the locker room. As soon as we know what's going on with him, we'll pass it on to you. Second down and two at the 25. Here's Wright. And he gets to the 28-yard line. Eric Barton with the tackle.
You know, you mentioned the thing about Marshawn Lynch being out of the lineup. Anthony Thomas, who is the normal number one backup for the Buffalo Bills, is not suited up today. He had a scratched cornea and was questionable as of yesterday. It just happened on Friday. They thought he might be able to play, but he did not. Jackson, the third running back, Freddie Jackson, really wasn't even expected to be active. In fact, Dick Geron told us not to expect Freddie Jackson to be active today, but he is because of Anthony Thomas. So Marshawn Lynch, his absence is troubling for the Bills.
Edwards rolling out of the pocket, and he dumps it off. Incomplete. Intended for Michael Gaines, the tight end. He couldn't hold on. And that will bring up second down and long. That's on the 28.
That was well defensed by the Jets. They had the downfield receivers covered, and the linemen and the pressure for Edwards, they let him roll out, and they came down the line. You see the three Jets right in front of him chasing him down. Just, you know, that's good defense. They're going to run him down, make him throw it, force the incompletion.
Second down and 10. And here's the handoff right. He stood up and driven backwards. How about that? David Harris and Kerry Rhodes both in on the play.
Yeah, the Jets coming off a blitz right on the outside, and Wright had nowhere to bounce this out. This was, the Bills were hoping the Jets would come off in coverage, and they didn't. You see there right at the bottom of your screen, that's Kerry Rhodes right off the corner, and that gets into a running back's vision right now, and that means he's just going to try and stuff it up in the middle because he can't bounce it outside, and that's really tough for a running back.
Third down and 9. Edwards in trouble. Incomplete. He was hit as he threw it. Revis again. They are in the backfield.
They are bringing all kinds of pressure off the corner against Edwards. Last time it was Rhodes, now it's Revis. For the second time we've seen it, he gets another hit on Edwards. That's the plan for the Jets. It's obvious. They're coming with pressure off the corner and forcing Edwards to throw it right now, and they're going to get some hits on him doing that.
So Buffalo will punt it away. Mormon, one of the best punters in the NFL, and that one off the side of his foot. No flag, and it's picked up Washington, and he'll get out of bounds. And there is a flag at the 39-yard line. A 42-yard punt and an 8-yard return. Let's see.
Personal foul, face mask, number 53 of the kicking team. The 15-yard penalty will be added on to the end of the run.
That's Mario Hagan called for the penalty. So coming up, the Jets with the football and a terrific opportunity. They'll have great field position.
We advance in leaps and bounds from generation to generation. At Acura, we help people advance. From where they are to where they could be. Acura. Advance.
Are you easily distracted? Avoiding others? Is it affecting your home life? You may be a numismatist, a collector of coins. But now there's a cure. Genuine United States Mint coins, like the Presidential $1 Coin Proof Set. These coin sets may cause euphoria, insomnia, and are extremely habit-forming. If you're a numismatist, now there's hope for you. Visit usmint.gov. United States meant genuinely worthwhile.
I'll start with the fans. I like those questions.
Coach, how does Coors Light deliver such awesome refreshment?
To do that, you've got to have protection.
Right, the Frost Brew Liner. It really protects that Rocky Mountain refreshment.
Would any coach say that's not genius?
There's not another coach in the National Football League that would say that. And if he did, he'd be wrong.
Word. Frost Brew Coors Light, official beer sponsor of the NFL.
Coach, he had 3 sacks of mini burgers in the first game.
And 5 sacks in the second ball game. So that's 8 sacks in 2 games.
They're mini burgers.
Did you vote yet? Vote for Pro Bowl.
He's the new president of France. So what made him storm out of a 60 Minutes interview? Find out tonight on 60 Minutes.
Welcome back to the Meadowlands. Our game tied at 3 apiece. Under 4 minutes to play in the second quarter. Jets will play with the short field. First down and 10 at the Buffalo 48. Thomas Jones in the backfield with Chad Pennington out of the guns. Play fake. Pennington down the seam. Caught. Cotchery. At the 26. Wilson with the tackle, but it's a gain of 21.
And that was a nice throw right into the teeth of the wind, too, right at midfield. Play action freezes the defense, and Pennington gets rid of it right down the hash. Perfect throw right in the heart of the defense.
Jets quickly to the line of scrimmage. First down at the 27. Here's Jones, flag on the play, and he's wrapped up. John McCargo.
And that's going to be a defensive offsides in the neutral zone. The Bills got too quick a jump.
Offside, defense, number 97, lining up in the neutral zone. 5-yard penalty. Replay first down.
And Marshawn Lynch back on the sideline for Buffalo. They were taking a look at his hip. We saw him walking on the sideline, look as if he was okay. So first down and 5 at the 22. Here's the pitch to Jones. Taking his time. Kicks his way. Stiff arm out of bounds. At the 19, DiGiorgio pushes him out of bounds after a gain of 2 yards.
There are two things about the Jets in this game. They are getting a lot of pressure on Trent Edwards, and their running game is taking over offensively. They've really done a nice job up front. And Thomas Jones is a much better back, I think, than the Bills anticipated. He is really running very well.
Jets have rushed for 63 yards in the first half. Second and 3 of the 20. Jones again, straight ahead. And this time Crowell gets him. John McCargo got a piece as well after a 2-yard pickup. Should be the last play before the 2-minute warning.
And the New York Jets once again driving the football after the turnover from the Buffalo Bills. And the Bills once again waiting until the Jets get down inside the 20-yard line before they stiffen.
2 minutes remaining in the first half. Our score, 3 apiece. The Jets, however, knocking on the door. Back after this.
Life is busy, but some people seem to get more done than others. Multitaskers. They found a way to do several things all at once. And when the Palm Central was designed, Sprint thought of these people. Then we gave it Sprint speed. You can email, text, chat, go online so fast.
People may wonder how many of you there really are.
Introducing the Palm Central, only from Sprint, on the fastest national mobile broadband network.
What if your entire business could learn to minimize risks? Well, off the course anyway, because change happens. Zurich.
Something new to crave. The CR-V from Honda.
You guys got any paper plates? You know, they measure them diagonally. You have a plunger.
At least you can keep your heartburn from coming back with Prilosec OTC, the only OTC heartburn remedy that works for 24 hours with one pill a day, the round-the-clock heartburn blocker.
Round-the-clock blocks, brought to you by Prilosec OTC. In a win over the Vikings, the Cowboys' Chris Canty blocked a Ryan Longwell field goal attempt that Pat Watkins recovered and returned for a touchdown.
Watkins to midfield! Watkins to the 30! Pat Watkins returns the blocked field goal, and the Cowboys have taken the lead!
Block heartburn for 24 hours with one pill a day. Round-the-clock blocks, brought to you by Prilosec OTC.
A boy's beautiful mind.
Mathematical ability off the charts.
Cost him his life.
Social security number is still in use.
You think you are? New cold case, then an ultimate fighting champion, pays the ultimate price.
You may think you fight dirty, but trust me, you ain't seen nothing yet.
New shark after new cold case, CBS Tonight.
You don't want to get hit with one of those things, Steve. Hulk hands.
That's right. It's not that cold, but he's certainly ready to go into the game, I think.
I don't know, the way the Jets are running the football now, Buffalo may feel like they're getting hit with a couple of big meat hooks like that.
Yeah, big green hammers hitting them today.
Third down and one. Thomas Jones has been terrific early on. Eight carries, close to 40 yards. And now, new quarterback in Brad Smith. He played quarterback at Missouri. Good runner. They hand it off to Washington inside. Fumble! Fumble. Buffalo has it.
Gus, Chad Pennington was on the field and then split out wide, a trick play that blows up right in the Jets' face.
Hey, everybody, check this out. Who wants white meat?
Tradition meets innovation. Lockable in-bed trunk on the Ridgeline, built by Honda.
When you think of it, children have always been able to put a smile on your face. Why not do something to put a smile on theirs? Join us in supporting Ronald McDonald House Charities as we make the lives a little brighter for children and their families all over the world.
Look, there's a moose. Give me a noose. I'm lost again. Where's Highway 10? This isn't good. Bad neighborhood. Went to buy a wreath. He's got no teeth.
Ding. Dong,
I miss my turn. I'm gonna burn. Wife's gonna freak. Future is weak. Nothing looks right. It's really bite. Where's Highway 10?
There's a moose again.
Give a garment.
Give a garment.
Screen clear and wide. Whole world inside. Garment.com. Garment.com.
Go!
Woo! Go!
All right, Daddy. This is it.
The Amazing Race is a love letter to the planet.
Just listen to me.
I am so proud of you.
Wow.
You know, what a gift.
The Amazing Race.
I didn't want to disappoint her.
The new season premieres next Sunday after 60 Minutes.
Amazing. Amazing.
Only on CBS.
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by Coors Light's Cold Activated Bottle. When the mountains turn blue, your beer is cold and ready for kickoff. And by McDonald's.
Welcome back. Our game tied at 3 apiece, 1:54 to play in the first half. Chad Pennington and the New York Jets offense with a golden opportunity there, but a fumble on the play, and Buffalo takes over at the 17-yard line. Marshawn Lynch back in the game. Edwards. And he throws, and it's caught at the 30-yard line. This time it's Josh Reed with the reception, and it's a gain of 13.
This is the trick play. Smith at quarterback, and you see they kind of go conservative, and that was a fumble. Aaron Schobel, second forced fumble he's had today. Kelsey comes down with it. Bill's ball going the other way.
Here's Edwards, fires, and it's incomplete, intended for Roscoe Parrish. As he short arms that football, standing on the play, David Harris.
It's a penalty flag on that one, too, in the backfield.
Personal foul, roughing the passer, late hit on the quarterback, defense number 24. 15-yard penalty, automatic, first down.
That's Darrell Revis.
He's coming
right here. And he's gotten been there all day. You know he's coming. And you can't. He put his head down. I don't know if I like the call. They're going to call that a lot, but I think that's one on the no call end of the spectrum I would look at. But they've been doing that all game. You can look for it. I'll bet he comes again on this play. They are sending a guy off the corner every single time. Here he comes.
Here's Edwards again, and this time Evans with the catch on the screen. And he gets to midfield, 1:22 to play. Buffalo with three timeouts. And a timeout on the field with 1:18 to go. This is the trick play. Pennington was at the top of your screen. Why do you run a trick play in a situation
like
that?
Well, it seems like a trick play, but you have guys. You're going to run the football, so it's not really like throwing the football all over. But you guys got guys handling the football who aren't used to it.
Sweetie, got you this new phone with a full keyboard because you're my number one. Hey, honey. Got you this great phone from Verizon Wireless because you're my number one. There you are. Got you this new phone with VCast.
Awesome.
Because, you know, you're my number one.
Saving the best for numero uno. That's right.
Get a great deal on these cool Samsung phones. Plus, join the Verizon Wireless family share plan and add a line for $9.99. Verizon Wireless.
Hey, sweetheart!
I have to leave tonight.
What?
Look, it's a business situation that I'm in with my brother.
No, no, I am through with this relationship.
I'm not.
I can't take it anymore.
I can take it still.
Every relationship has its secrets.
My brother's Santa Claus.
Yeah, I can see that.
This year, make this a Christmas to remember.
The hockey stop?
Vince Vaughn, Paul Giamatti.
I just can't stay mad at you.
Fred Claus, rated PG. Starts Friday, November 9th.
So now what do we do?
Fight. Last one standing gets the promotion. Survival of the fittest.
I want the promotion!
Delivery guy, you don't even work here.
Do more than just survive the work week. A better job awaits at careerbuilder.com.
Well, the Jets lost their second fumble of 2007 when Washington let it go inside the 20. Last week, there was a fumbled center quarterback exchange between Chad Pennington and Nick Mangold as center. The Jets generally very good holding on to the football, but back-to-back weeks they've made mistakes. Second and six at the 49 for Buffalo. Here's Edwards in trouble, fires incomplete, intended for Josh Reed, and he was under pressure. Dwayne Robertson in the backfield.
Well, that's the story of the first half for the Jets defense. They are pressuring Edwards every single time he drops back. Somebody is coming in and he's ending up on the ground. And that's going to take its toll sooner or later. It's already resulted in one interception, but you know that more sacks and problems are going to come if they don't solve it as a Buffalo Bill offense.
Third down and six at the 49. They need to go to the 45 for a first down. Flag on the play. Edwards rolling out, fires. Jackson squares his shoulders, gets out of bounds. Short of the first down, Revis there defensively for New York.
I think this penalty flag is going to be on Buffalo for an illegal formation.
Illegal formation, offense. Number 83 was covering up the end on the line of scrimmage. 5-yard penalty, replay third down.
And don't forget, coming up on the Sprint Halftime Report, join JB, Dan, Shannon, Boomer, and Coach C for all the latest NFL scores and highlights. That's coming up on the Sprint Halftime Report. Third down and 11 at the 44 for Buffalo. They'll have to go to the Jets' 45-yard line. Dick Geron, great player at Yale, played in the NFL with the Detroit Lions and the Cincinnati Bengals.
And the pressure's going to come from the bottom again.
They hand it off. Jackson. That's an interesting call,
well,
Steve.
Well, that is a conservative call to try and get out of this half without giving up any more points. They're going to punt it away. They got one of, if not the best punter in the National Football League. They're going to try and pin the Jets back and go in at halftime 3-3.
57 seconds remaining in the first half.
Robert Neville,
2012.
I am broadcasting on all AM frequencies. I am a survivor living in New York City.
If anyone is out there, please, you are not alone.
I am Legend.
And welcome back. Gus Johnson, Steve Tasker with you as you take a look at some of the statistics. At the bottom of your screen, Buffalo punting it away. Mormon, wobbly kick. Washington signals for the fair catch and has it at the 11-yard line. A 44-yard punt with 52 seconds remaining. Here come the Jets back on offense.
And now the Jets with 52 seconds, Gus. Now Thomas Jones won't be as big a factor because they won't be able to run the ball as well, although they have timeouts left. Both clubs with two.
Jets with a golden opportunity to take the lead, but Coach Schottenheimer, the offensive coordinator, electing to call a conservative trick play, as you mentioned, and it cost them big. Fumbling the football. First down at the 12 for Pennington. Washington in the backfield. Here's Pennington. Fires Washington, and he's wrapped up and taken down immediately by Kyle Williams.
Yeah,
the fans here don't like that call.
Well, this is where, if you're going to criticize Chad Pennington and his arm strength, this is the situation in which you do it. He's not going to throw the football deep. They're going into the wind, and this is exactly the type of situation where you need a guy with a cannon for an arm, and Chad Pennington is not that guy.
A loss of four, second and 14.
Snap off. One more play.
Here's Washington on the handoff. And that'll do it. DiGiorgio with the tackle. So we head into the locker room. Don't forget, coming up on the Sprint Halftime Report, join JB, Dan, Shannon, Boomer, and Coach Cower for all the latest NFL scores and highlights. That's coming up on the Sprint Halftime Report. Our score tied at 3 at the end of the first half. We'll be back with the Sprint Halftime Report after this message and a word from your local station. You're watching the National Football League on CBS.
After Halloween, it's a CSI treat when an actress is axed.
Are you trying to make me throw up?
This place is creeping me out.
A new CSI then.
We got two dead and a Kelly Schmidt who's nowhere to be found. I'm sorry, I gotta sit down for a second. I'm pregnant.
New Without a Trace after CSI, CBS Thursday.
The number one comedy, 2.5 Men, tomorrow on CBS.
They use it to shoot the game. They use it to broadcast the game. They use it to produce the game.
The main man on the field today is Peyton Manning.
So why wouldn't you use it to watch the game?
That's Peyton Manning.
Nice, Tony. Scoot over a bit, will you?
Nothing compares to a Sony Bravia HD TV because high definition is in our DNA.
Anybody got any chips?
Go on an NBA road trip with the NBA League Pass Early Bird offer. See the new-look Celtics in the East, and who will challenge the Spurs, Suns, and Mavericks in the West?
Oh, that is special!
Experience the intensity of NBA basketball at home or online with NBA League Pass Broadband. Get NBA League Pass from DirecTV now for just $159. To order and save $20, call 1-800-GET-SPORTS or visit DirecTV.com. Don't miss a minute of the live action. Get NBA League Pass now.
A little surprise.
I'm pregnant.
Is taking Nick Persons to the country.
It's a really amazing place to raise a family.
We'll take it.
To build a home.
I can fix that.
Mm-hmm.
And to build a family.
I think you're a cool son.
You're a cool dad.
Shh. Kevin!
Are We Done Yet? Now available on pay-per-view.
At least the table's strong.
CBS.
CBS Sports presents the Sprint Halftime Report. Sprint, proud sponsor and avid fans of the NFL.
And welcome back to New York and the Sprint Halftime Report. I'm James Brown, along with my colleagues Dan Marino, Bill Cowher, Shannon Sharp, and Boomer Esiason. And the score at halftime is a purist type. What, Bill?
3-3. Y'all love right, that defense, yeah. Man.
Go ahead, Bill. Not a lot of exciting stuff going on here, guys. Darrell Revis, the rookie right there. That's pretty exciting if you're a family member. And then here comes Brad Smith, the quarterback. Hands off to Leon Washington. Aaron Schobel forces the fumble. So if you're related to Aaron Schobel, you're happy. 3-3 at half.
All right, Coach.
Well, I'll tell you what. How about this? Here we go. You're going to look for it. You can't find it. Tom Brady's going to run it himself. And how about this? Pass to Mike Vrabel, ties him for his touchdown record on Tom Brady's 28th and Mike Vrabel's 10th touchdown reception.
Ladies and gentlemen, look at this coin flip by Arnold Schwarzenegger. No. Is that horrible or what? If you want to score a touchdown in this game, you must be named Antonio. Gates wide open, 49 yards. His first, he would have a 31-yard later. Minimize the damage, Coach. Just fall on the football. All you have to do, Matt Turk, and he falls on the ground, Antonio Cromartie picks it up. It's 14-0. Antonio Cromartie has the touchdown. He's going to match Antonio Gates, who already has two. He goes down to one arm, one hand, and now he's headed the other way. That's the 405 freeway. I think he's headed to San Bernardino, and he's in the end zone. 28-3, JB.
And the Jaguars here. Jeff Garcia, play action pass. He hasn't been intercepted in a while. Aaron Glenn jumps, and he goes 28 yards, putting Jacksonville up 17-3. Then Jeff Garcia comes back once again. Here, watch. Play action. Time to throw. Wouldn't you think he'd cover Joey Galloway? No, they don't cover him. He goes 58 yards for a touchdown, getting them within 7 points.
Drew Brees is going to drop back right here, hook up with Marcus Colston for 17 yards and a touchdown. And the 49ers with absolutely no offense. You're going to see Maurice Hicks fumbling the football, picked up by Scott Fuita of New Orleans. They will kick a field goal, and right now it's a 10-0 New Orleans lead.
All right, early game, Shannon.
Into Joe Lavernous, his second touchdown. He had two rushing, one receiving. This one right here. Being a tested early, if you're an old athlete, you can't move as fast. He gets stepped on, come out the ball game. Iced out Achilles, Benny, it'll be okay. Peyton Manning up top. Love down below,
nice.
Reggie Wayne.
Whoa.
11 carries, a buck 68, one touchdown. And Joseph Adai, he had 23 carries and a feed note. That's 100 yards, JB.
Yes, indeed.
Hey, that's it on the date. They win.
And the Raiders, Sebastian Janikowski, he hits a 50-yard field goal here, which makes him the all-time leading field goal kicker in Raiders history. With Tennessee being very physical, ran the ball all day. This is Chris Henry, 24-yard touchdown. Tennessee ran it for 192 yards on the day. Dante Culpepper trying to bring his team back. Last final drive, throws it to Mike Williams. He drops it, fourth down. Tennessee wins.
And Pittsburgh goes down to Cincinnati. Ben Roethlisberger, two touchdowns on the day, both of them to Hines Ward and Willie Parker. Yes, Willie Parker next to LT, one of the better backs in the league. 126 yards. You're going to see right here, taking it in for a touchdown. Pittsburgh on the day now goes a 5-2. Another win down in Cincinnati.
All right, how about Cleveland going to St. Louis? Here's Steven Jackson. He starts for the first time in 4 weeks, but then re-injures his back and does not come back in the game. Derek Anderson, 18 of 25, 248 yards and 3 touchdowns. What a great game by the young quarterback. Right here, he finds Braylon Edwards, who also had a big game for them. 8 catches, 117 yards and 2 touchdowns. Lee Bodden seals the victory with an interception right there for Romeo Crennel and the Cleveland Browns.
And it rained a whole game in Wembley Stadium in London, and it made it difficult for both quarterbacks. But Eli Manning, he pulls it down. He outruns Jason Taylor for a touchdown. He was only 8 of 22 for 59 yards passing. You see the ball handling there. The ball came out of Cleo Lemon's hands. Michael Strahan picks it up. Then you got right here. Who's this? This is Fred Robinson coming up with another sack. Cleo Lemon struggled. They win by 3. Giants.
Can anybody figure out the Philadelphia Eagles? The one thing you got to know is that Brian Westbrook's going to be involved. 21 carries, 46 yards, 1 touchdown. He also caught the ball 4 times for 46 yards and a touchdown. Kelly Holcomb right here, the starting quarterback for Minnesota, gets hurt on this play, does not play the rest of the game. Brooks Bollinger comes in, doesn't do enough. 23-16, Philadelphia goes into Minnesota and wins.
Detroit got a big day from Kevin Jones. 23 carries, feed note and change. That's 105 yards, JB in a tub. And puts him up. 10-0. Brian Greasy brings them back. Ooh, 13-7, JB. Chicago's getting back in it, but Brian Greasy, his fourth and final INT of the day. Fernando Bryant picks him off. And they lose 16-7 to Chicago, losing 16-7 to Detroit.
All right, so that's the wrap-up of all that has been taking place in the NFL. We'll take you back to the second half of the Bills and the Jets after this.
CBS Sports presents the Sprint Halftime Report. Sprint, proud sponsor and avid fans of the NFL.
Powerhouse survivor James has an immunity idol.
One of these.
Could he find another, or will it fall into someone else's hands?
Not as dumb as I look.
And it's time to outwit and outplay the castaways in a unique immunity challenge. If you miss a moment, you miss the clues. New Survivor China, CBS Thursday.
Play Sprint Speed Fantasy against the NFL Today team for a chance to win a $5,000 grand prize. The guys have made their picks. Think you can do better? Go to cbssports.com/sprint.
I know I made a mistake. I listened to my mom, but just not on the football field all the time. My mom started me in football when I was 7 years old. That was her way of keeping me out of trouble, keeping me off the streets, so something constructive to do. She expects me to play well. She only points out the mistakes. If we win, it don't matter, only when we lose. I love you. Bye, Mom. Yeah, I listen to her, just, you know, from afar.
That's good chili, Joe.
Clifford family recipe.
You boys see Jeff Garcia's number Sunday?
I'm tearing up my fantasy league.
This is Exhibit A on why fantasy football is un-American.
Oh, this should be good.
Garcia throws for 300 yards.
316.
316 in a losing cause, and that makes you the big winner?
Yes.
Is this what the founding fathers had in mind? What about allegiance to team?
Well, starting Garcia was a pretty sweet call.
True. If you're a communist.
Joe was surrounded by Reds.
Next Sunday, the NFL on CBS features the super matchup of the year. The unbeaten Patriots versus the undefeated Colts. And your ticket to the game starts on the NFL Today at 12 noon. CBS Sports presents the Sprint Halftime Report. Sprint, proud sponsor and avid fans of the NFL.
Halftime with the score. Jets and Bills tied at 3. We'll return to the Meadowlands after this message and a word from your local station. You're watching the National Football League on CBS.
CSI Miami, tomorrow on CBS.
For great college football from across the country, you need ESPN Game Plan from DirecTV. Covering many of the best teams and conferences, ESPN Game Plan has up to 12 games every Saturday from outside your local area. Order now by calling 1-800-GET-SPORTS for a full season of great college football with ESPN Game Plan from DirecTV. Only two payments of $64.50. Order now at 1-800-GET-SPORTS or go to DirecTV.com/GamePlan.
Okay, give me my remote.
Get it, Jim. You had way too much cable.
You said you were going to get DirecTV.
I'm fine. Really.
So digital picture doesn't mean anything to you? But what about your friends and your family?
I just want to watch the game.
That's the cable talking, Jim. That game isn't even in HD.
Friends don't let friends watch cable. Refer a friend or family member to DirecTV, and you'll get $50, and they'll get $50 on top of our best offer.
Surprise. Whoa! Will the kids find in the secret mine shaft?
This is so freaky.
Oh my god!
New Kid Nation, CBS Wednesday, Halloween night.
Oh, Chatty Cathy, oh, Chatty Cathy, of Mattel's famous talking dog. We call the ring, and you say 11 different things.
My car insurance rates are too high. Really? I just saved a bunch by switching to Geico.
Just pull the ring. You never know what she'll say next.
Pull that string one more time. I dare ya.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Well, both teams established the run early, eating up a lot of time. Eventually, though, the Jets' pressure paid off. Darrell Revis, the impressive rookie, with his first career interception. But the Jets were unable to take advantage, fumbling their opportunity away. And as we head into the second half, our score is tied at 3. Welcome back to the Meadowlands. Gus Johnson along with Steve Tasker. Opportunities for both teams, mistakes by both teams.
Well, in this game, 3-3 is a fitting score. It is a tie. They've got the same number of total yards. They've each got a turnover. They punted once each. I think the thing is, though, Buffalo has gotten 2 sacks on Chad Pennington, but I think the pressure by the Jets has been the difference for Buffalo's offense. Both these clubs are playing it tooth and nail, and I think, too, at the end of that first half, both coaches showed a little bit of conservative nature. Eric Mangini not trying to get the ball out of there with Chad Pennington, and also Buffalo punting the football away to get with a minute left instead of trying to get the first down out at midfield.
So the Jets will have it to start the second half. A reminder, this game is brought to you at high definition here on CBS.
Buffalo will punt or kick off into the wind. You see, you get an idea of how windy it is. Now they have to have a guy hold the ball on the tee. And that's a rarity.
Kawaki Thomas will hold it for Ryan Lindell. Leon Washington, the very dangerous return man, back deep. He leads the NFL in kickoff return average, 33.2.
It's a mortar kick.
It's a short one. And Baker picks it up. Right place, right time.
And that was a deliberate short mortar kick by the Bills trying to get that ball. And it did bounce once, which is exactly what they wanted to do. And the Jets handled it exactly how they were supposed to. And here's the first half statistics.
Take us through them, Steve.
Well, they're dead even. The Bills are having a little more success through the air. The Jets are having more success on the ground. And I tell you what, if I'm the Jet offense, Gus, I'm giving the ball to Thomas Jones and daring the Bills to stop me in the second half.
Thomas Jones in the first half, 8 carries, 39 yards. First down and 10 at the 33. Pennington sets up, fires to the sideline, incomplete. That one overthrown, intended for Lavernous Coles. Crowell in the backfield, bearing down on Chad Pennington.
And I'll tell you what, the Jets escaped a holding call as Crowell got into the backfield. Somebody had his shirt tail, but the Jets, Chad Pennington switching out of a play, and then the Bills counter-switching with the different defense that looked like they were going to be up in tight man-to-man. And when Pennington changed the play, the Bills backed off. You see there, he was held there on Adrian Clark getting away with it.
Second down and 10. Pennington again, short drive. Steps up in the pocket and he's wrestled down. Aaron Schobel with the tackle. And the Jets start the second half.
And this is going to go down as a sack, even though it's almost to the line of scrimmage. Didn't quite get it. The Bills had a game on down inside the tackles. Watch as Schobel's going to come down underneath McCargo on the inside and get down as Pennington steps up. He steps right into Aaron Schobel, and that's something no doubt they talked about at halftime.
First two plays, very sloppy for the Jets. Third down and 11 at the 32. Pennington. Here's Chad Pennington with time. Dumps it off to Jones, and he's tackled from behind by John DiGiorgio. 5-yard gain, but New York will have to punt it away. And that was a very sloppy series, especially to start the second half.
Yeah, and I don't like the success they had in the first half of the running game, then not even handing the ball off to Thomas Jones at the beginning of the series of the second half. I know you've got the win, but he was your best weapon, and only with a dump-off pass does he get an opportunity here.
Graham sends it away. Roscoe Parrish lets it go over his head, and it will go into the end zone. Buffalo will have it at the 20, but there is a flag down on the play at the 45-yard line.
The penalties were a problem for Buffalo in the first half.
holding receiving team number 53. The 10-yard penalty would be added to the dead ball spot. First down, Buffalo.
That's Mario Hagan's second penalty called against him.
He had the
today.
Personal foul. He had the personal foul face mask in the first half.
We'll step away. Start of the third quarter. Now Dick Geron's offense will get their opportunity.
Time for the coin toss. Visiting team, call it in the air. Want a good, clean game. We're all professionals here.
You can change for a dollar.
Want to get away?
Now you can. Get your game on with Southwest Airlines and Visa. Go to southwest.com and use your Visa card to tackle fares from $49 to $109. There's no better way to be in the game. Suit up and purchase by October 29th.
Truckers say if you can haul 10,300 pounds, you darn well better be able to stop 10,300 pounds. This Tundra's four oversized disc brakes don't mess around. Its beefed up engine takes care of the rest. Looks like man's got a new best friend. Available on the full-size Tundra. The truck that's changing it all.
Fred Flintstone, an employee of Slate Rock Gravel Company. His wife, Wilma, a stay-at-home mom. Yet on this working man's salary, how did Wilma afford a necklace made of huge rocks?
Mr. Slate pays well, but he doesn't pay that well.
An investigation would reveal that Fred had the Flintmobile insured with Geico, saving the couple untold amounts of money. Their friendship with the Rubbles would soon become strained.
Geico, 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
When his family is threatened...
These guys put my brother in the hospital.
Even a good man has to cross the line.
You sure you want to do this?
This is what has to be done.
King, new episode, CBS Tuesday.
This telecast is copyrighted by the NFL for the private use of our audience. Any other use of this telecast or of any pictures, descriptions, or accounts of the game without the NFL's consent is prohibited.
Welcome back, Buffalo, with the football. First and 10 at their own 10-yard line. Trent Edwards, the rookie, started 7 of 7, 60 yards. Since then, he's gone 3 for 8, 25 yards with an interception. Marshawn Lynch starts the second half in the backfield. He's the deep man in the eye, and a whistle.
False start, offense, number 71. 5-yard penalty, still first down.
And that's the left tackle, Jason Peters. Both teams sloppy to start this second half.
Yeah, they really are. Offensively, both teams are tripping over themselves to get it started. The Buffalo Bills already with a 10-yard penalty to get him back off the 20. Now another 5-yarder by that guy, Jason Peters.
First down at 15. Here's Lynch. And Lynch gets to the 10-yard line before being ridden down. Eric Barton in on the play. Marshawn Lynch taking it to the locker room toward the end of the first half. They looked at his hip. He came back out, loosened up, and got back on the field. Here he is starting the second half. Lynch in the first half. 7 carries. 8 carries, 26 yards so far. Edwards to the far side, caught, Royal. And he gets down close to the first down marker at the 20. Revis defensively for the Jets. A gain of 10.
And that's really a bigger play than a 10-yard gain for the Bills, or an 8-yard gain. That gets them down to third and two or three, something where they could throw or pass. Robert Royal's a guy who's been a real steadying influence for this offense, not just in his production, but his personality and his ability to calm guys down.
Third down and 2 at the 18. Right in the backfield now for Buffalo. Here's Edwards, short drop underneath, ball caught. Terrific catch, Josh Reed, and an even better run after the catch. Elam brings him down, but it's a gain of 18.
Well, we spoke earlier that all three receivers, the top three receivers for the Bills, are very different. Josh Reed is a physical receiver. He's not big, but he's very strong, built like a running back. And you see there, that's exactly what he did. Caught the ball, ducked his head, and plowed ahead to the 35-yard line.
4 catches, 40 yards for the former Biletnikoff Award winner out of LSU in 2001. First down at the 36. Here's the handoff. This time it's right. And right stopped by Sione Bouha. I've been practicing that one all day.
And right coming in, Marshawn Lynch and right alternating. Nothing seems to be bothering Lynch. He's back in the game as his jet defense had the Bills on the ropes. And now one quick slant pass out and the Bills are out of trouble.
Second down and six from the 39. Lynch back in the game with Derek Schumann, the up back. Read the motion man. Edwards wants to throw it. Finds his back out of the backfield as Lynch squares his shoulders. Whoa, he takes a hard hit, but falls forward. Barton again wraps him up, but it's a 7-yard gain for the rookie out of Cal. First down.
Well, we knew Eric Barton and Marshawn Lynch were going to get to know each other today, and this is why Trent Edwards and why the Buffalo Bills have liked him. He keeps his eyes down the field and trusts that the checkoff is going to be there. And that hurts. But talk to Barton, and the word he used to describe Marshawn Lynch and how he's played so far as a rookie has been great.
First down at the 46. Play fake. Edwards rolls. Dumps it off. Gaines, the tight end, lowers his shoulder and drags a couple of green jerseys down to the 42. Brian Thomas jumped on for a ride, but it's a 12-yard pickup for Big Mike Gaines out of Central Florida.
Well, the first is right there. He's going to come out. And the first drive, the first possession after halftime is always crucial for all the teams. The Jets did not do very well offensively. The Bills have had better success because it gives the offensive coaches and the defensive coaches a chance to make adjustments. And it looks like now the Bills' offense have made some pretty good adjustments.
First down at the 43. Marshawn Lynch looking, finds a crease, gets to the 40, maybe inside the 40. Eric Barton again. And it's a 4-yard gain.
Now, we spoke to Eric Barton on Friday, and we said, you know, you're going to be out there with a rookie linebacker, David Harris, who's going to call the signals. And he said, yeah, I told him to. Well, Eric Barton, the veteran, usually calls the signals. He said, I don't like to call signals because I have to turn my back on the offense. And you see there, that's the average, and that's a good day for the Jet defense. But Harris, the rookie, in for Jonathan Vilma, who's placed on IR this week, calling the signals for the Jets defense.
Second and seven at the 40. Edwards has hit 8 different receivers. Here's the delayed handoff. And the ball comes loose, but it should be dead. Marshawn Lynch running it once again as David Harris gets to him first.
And this Jet defense now against the run in this game, they have played much, much better against the Buffalo Bills. Now, this Jet team faced this Bills team with Trent Edwards as starter just 3 weeks ago. And you see here, this is what they've been really struggling with. Rush yards game, they're 28th. And then, of course, takeaways, 30th. You got to get more takeaways if you're the Jets defense.
Third down and 5 of the 38. Buffalo 3 of 7 on conversions. Here's Edwards under pressure. Somehow stays on his feet, but he goes down. David Harris finally gets to him, the rookie. And Buffalo will have to punt it away.
That was a great pressure coming right up the middle. Both linebackers right up inside over the guards, and Edwards ducks. It looked like for a moment he was going to escape, but he rolls the wrong way right back into the defender, Harris.
So that brings on Brian Moorman to punt. Leon Washington stands at the 10-yard line. Moorman at his own 44. Wobbly kick off the side of his foot. Washington fields it at the 15 and goes down at the 19-yard line. Special teams tackle made by John Wendley. A 27-yard punt, a 4-yard return. Gang Green ganging up on the rookie.
I've gone ahead and equipped my epic axe.
Switching to explosive arrows.
Yeah, I'm gonna equip myself with a little, four wheels of fury!
No way. There's no trucks in World of Warcraft.
Let's do this! Did you see me lay down the law? I am the lawgiver!
Where can I get one of those?
Let's go. Okay.
You wouldn't make it in pro football, but you can dominate your fantasy league with VCast. Watch CBS Sports programming, get fantasy analysis, stats, and more. Only from Verizon Wireless.
Have people noticed a change in you? You may be a numismatist, a coin collector. But now there's hope. Genuine United States Mint coins. Visit usmint.gov. Genuinely worthwhile.
When you think of it, children have always been able to put a smile on your face. Why not do something to put a smile on theirs? Join us in supporting Ronald McDonald House Charities as we make the lives a little brighter for children and their families all over the world.
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by Southwest Airlines. With Southwest Airlines' convenient nonstop flights, it's like having your own company plane. GEICO, 15 minutes could save you 15% on car insurance. And by Toyota, moving forward.
Welcome back. Jets with the football at their own 19. Pennington starts in the shotgun on first down. Handing it off, Thomas Jones. And he'll get to the 24-yard line. Kyle Williams with the tackle as you take a look at their last four possessions.
Well, that's just not good enough. There was two punts and a fumble plus into the first half when they actually just kind of ran the football and let the clock run out.
No huddle offense being utilized now by New York. Second and five. Jones again following his block. And he spins, dives forward. Picks up a first down. George Wilson, the safety, comes up and makes the tackle, but it's a gain of seven.
I tell you, Gus, I've
given him the ball.
I know. Why are they giving it to anybody else? That guy is, Thomas Jones is killing the Buffalo Bills in the run game, and the Jets continue to do other things offensively before the Bills have learned how to stop it.
10 carries, 51 yards, and you just get the feeling that if they keep feeding Thomas Jones, he's going to break a big one. He's averaging 5.1 yards per carry. Running it again, spinning, look at it, pops it outside, lowers his shoulder. Hey, coach, it's my day. Let's take a look. Thomas Jones running and catching.
And he's really starting to emerge as a guy who can do everything. He's got speed to go outside. And like I said earlier, he always looks like he wants to go up the field, which always makes the defense freeze their feet. And then that opens it up for him to go get around the corner. The guy's a great instinctive runner.
Second down and three at the 37. Cotchery, the motion man. There's Pennington. Underneath, deflected, almost picked off. Dangerous. Angelo Crowell, the outside linebacker, got two hands on the football.
I'll tell you what, he picks that off, it's a touchdown. And I understand keeping a defense honest, but that almost turned into disaster.
So it brings up third down and three at the 37. The Jets are 1 of 5 on third down conversions. Leon Washington comes into the game. Buffalo looks like they may bring pressure. Here they come on the blitz. Pennington hit as he throws, incomplete.
And he was hit hard by Kelsey. Got the football away. But you knew, I mean, everybody in the stadium knew the Bills were coming with pressure. They were lined up for it. And they got there quick, but Pennington quicker to get the ball off. But just couldn't make it accurate, and that's his game. If he can't throw it accurately, he may as well not throw it.
You just can't understand some of the decisions being made with the play call as the Jets punt it away. Parrish back deep from the 7. Flag on the play, Roscoe, and he's gobbled up at the 10-yard line by Smith.
And this is going to be a penalty in the Jet backfield, a hold. Dante Whitner rushed the punt, came up and under and got grabbed and put down right on the ground, right in front of the punter. And I think this will be tacked on at the end, although it was before the punt. I think it'll be tacked on at the end of the return.
And what you don't understand about that last series
holding, kicking team number 42.
Rashad Washington.
Re-kick.
So they'll re-kick it. Rashad Washington, you're absolutely right. But let me ask you a question. as we take a look at the penalty.
Right there, number 20 for the Bills. Whitner coming up, and Washington grabs him and just pulls him towards him just for a second before Whitner breaks loose.
But, Steve, let me ask you a question. The Jets had a first and 10 at the 31. They gave it to Thomas Jones. He picked up seven. They're faced with the second and three, and they didn't give it to him again. They continue to pass the football.
I think it's crazy. The guy had a phenomenal first half. I thought he was the thing that really was the positive for the Jets the whole game, and I just don't think they're giving it to him enough.
So the Jets will repunt it. This one off the side of Graham's foot, takes a bounce, fielded Parrish at the 25. Here comes Roscoe. Watch out! Parrish goes down at the 43-yard line. The punter, Graham, with the saving tackle, and Buffalo is in business.
And that was about a 40-yard penalty on the hold on the previous punt.
5:43 to play in the third. Back after this.
Truckers will tell you, commanding 10,000 pounds is hard. Keeping it in line? Downright hell. This truck's got a trapezoidal frame and big old leaf springs that'll help you stay on track. No, sir. Ain't nothing gonna wag this dog. Available on the full-size Tundra Crew Max. The truck that's changing it all.
I remember making snowboards by hand in my own garage. We couldn't afford the proper equipment, so there I was, applying polyurethane with a scuba mask on. Eventually, we started making some pretty good boards, but it still didn't catch on. People just didn't get it. Maybe it wasn't what we were saying, but how we were saying it. Then we found a way.
HP helps great companies like Burton build their brands. Get the tools to build yours online at hp.com/Burton.
Tomorrow, when the sky goes dark and the wolves begin to howl.
His DNA mimic canine profile.
Like a dog.
Like a wolf.
It's Halloween in Miami.
The sun is going down, and when it does, somebody else is going to die.
New CSM Miami, CBS Tomorrow.
Welcome back, Buffalo, with the football at the Jets' 44-yard line. Game tied at 3. 5:43 to play in the third quarter. Trent Edwards at the center. They give it to Marshawn Lynch. And Lynch, with a whole lot of running room over that left side, gets inside the 40. Gains 6 yards on the play. New England taking on the Redskins. Here's James Brown.
Hey, Gus and Steve, take a look at Brady here. Tom Brady faking the spike and hooking up with who else? Randy Moss. 29th touchdown toss this season for Brady, a career best. 24-0, they're spanking the Skins at the half. Gus and Steve.
All right, JB, second and 4 at the 38 now for Edwards. Drops back, fires out of the backfield, and it's incomplete. Ball intended for Robert Royal.
Kerry Rhodes tipped this at the line of scrimmage. And the Bills, once again, even the Bills kind of do it. They get away from handing that football off Marshawn Lynch. Running the ball down for 7 yards on first down, and then they decide to throw the quick pass. But you know, these offenses, particularly going into the wind, you might understand it, but neither offense really attempting to go deep today at all.
Third down and 4 at the 38. Lynch, the single setback. Royal, the motion man. Here's Edwards, dropping, fires to the sideline, and he just floats this one out of bounds.
Yeah, he threw that one away. You're right, Gus. Victor Hobson was right in his face, and the Bills are going to have to punt this away. Watch as Hobson at the top of your screen is going to come right off and ends up right on top of Marshawn Lynch, gives the great lookout block. And that's one of the things we mentioned. You see there, he went right by Marshawn Lynch, and that's one of the things the young back has really tried to work on, is to get pass protection.
Fourth straight punt for Mormon. Washington stands at the 10-yard line.
intentional delay of game.
They will give Mormon a little bit more room to drop this one.
Gives him more
inside
room.
Inside the 20.
Yeah, and plus we saw in the first half, and it's good discipline by the Jet defense. If they think they're going to snap it and jump off sides, it's a first down for the Bills, and the Bills don't have to do anything to get it. So they try it, give him 5 yards, and I think rightfully so,
game,
the Jets
team
will decline it.
5 yard penalty, fourth down.
I would decline it if I were the Jets. It's tougher to kick a high, short punt like that and keep it out of the end zone.
So Mormon is back at the 43. He pops this one in the air, wobbly. Washington with the fair catch at the 15-yard line, a 28-yard punt. So here comes Thomas Jones, 57 yards rushing, 25 yards receiving. Let's see if they go to him.
You don't want to be LeBron James. I can inspire you, impress you, make you believe that I am just one man. Nothing about my game is great yet. I still have work to do, more challenges to face, much more to learn, to be as good as I can be. But I do see the light. And it is up to me to go and get it. I am LeBron James. You don't want to be me. You want to be better than me.
Watching the NFL on CBS. The NFL on CBS is sponsored by Burger King, who reminds you to have it your way. And by HP. Explore your creativity at hp.com/whatdoyouhavetosay.
And welcome back. First down and 10 at the 16-yard line for the Jets. Out of the offset eye. Jones, the deep man, Cotchery in motion. Here's Thomas Jones, and this time he's bottled up and driven down. No gain on the play. As a matter of fact, he'll lose a yard. DeGiorgio in on the tackle. And prior to that run, Jones averaging over 5 yards a carry. How often should you give it to him?
I think you want to give it to your back. If he's running like he is today, he hasn't had any long, long runs. Give it to him until he's averaging about 4 yards a carry. Up to that point, he was 5.1. Give it to him until it's 4.1. But you don't always have to give it to him on first down. I think the Bills were expecting that run.
Second down and 11 at the 15. McCareins in motion. Jones again, no play action. Pennington to the sideline, and he underthrows a wide open. Cotchery.
And that, you hear the boos after that one incompletion, and that's a throw that it looks like Chad Pennington just didn't have the arm strength to get that ball all the way out there. And that's what his critics keep harping on, is his inability to make throws like this. From the right hash to the left sideline, 15 yards down, this ball just can't get there.
Pennington, 9 of 15, only 65 yards. Third down and 11 at the 15. They need to go to the 26. Buffalo showing blitz. And they back off of it. Pennington steps up, dumps it off, and they won't pick up the first down. Jones with the reception, but Angelo Crowell wraps him up. It's a 9-yard gain on third down at 11.
Well, they tried to get it to Jones, and there's Trent Edwards going off the field. And that's amazing that he's going off the field right now. If they had a question of whether he was going to be able to come back, Trent Edwards should have been off the field as soon as the Bills' offense was off the field.
So the Jets send it away. Parrish from the 19 will get a chance up the sideline. breaks it back, and he goes down at the 40. A 57-yard punt and a 22-yard return. Looks like we're going to see a new quarterback. The old quarterback, J.P. Lossman.
Isn't there a faster way you can do this?
No.
Doing things faster means waiting less. And with Sprint, you'll wait less to make calls with unlimited calling starting at 7 p.m. instead of 9. For more ways to wait less, go to waitless.org. Now get the new Motorazr 2 V9M with access to exclusive NFL content from Sprint.
Mark and Laura, 30 when they finished graduate school, repaying student loans, and then two children. Behind the eight ball? Yes. But drawing on the independent spirit that took them backpacking from Pittsburgh to Panama, they started working with people at TD Ameritrade, using planning tools, guidance, and research to help them catch up and move ahead. TD Ameritrade. Independence is the spirit that drives America's most successful investors.
A ghost ship with a missing crew.
We'll all be dead by morning.
A special Halloween episode. New NCIS. Then, it was supposed to be a routine transfer. Then something went terribly wrong. Ultimate Fighting Champ Randy Couture guest stars.
Oh, God.
The Unit. New episode after a new NCIS CBS Tuesday.
So, J.P. Lossman gets another opportunity as he comes in at quarterback. He was the starter at the beginning of the year, injured his knee, taken out of the lineup, and then beaten out by Edwards. Here's Lossman throwing on first down. This one caught by Schumann. Schumann dives forward and gets to midfield. Let's take a look back. Week three against the New England Patriots. Quarterback J.P. Lossman suffered a grade one sprain on his MCL. Lossman has practiced over the past couple of weeks. He was the team's backup quarterback last week against Baltimore. And the fourth-year quarterback has thrown for 255 yards with 30 completions on 47 attempts this season with one interception. Second down and one at midfield. Marshawn Lynch. And he picks up the first down. I guess that's why a coach always says, you have to stay ready, even when you're not in the game.
Yeah, and that's true. And these backup quarterbacks, being a backup quarterback is an art because you don't get a practice, you don't get a play. And if Trent Edwards were to come out of the tunnel ready to play, he would go back in the game because he did all the work to get ready. He knows the plays, he ran the plays in offense. The backup stands and watches. You can't get two guys ready to play. You can only get two guys half ready to play.
And for Trent Edwards, they are looking at his wrist in the locker room. Now, J.P. Lossman, different from Trent Edwards, he can run it a little bit. First down, Lossman to the sideline, incomplete. Intended for Lee Evans as he throws that one over his head.
And I think it's tough right now for J.P. Lossman. This is a guy that's used to being in there from the start. He's not used to coming in out off the bench or out of the bullpen. This is a guy that's used to playing the whole game. But let's face this, too. He's got some experience, and nothing. It's not going to rattle him to come in and be in this game. It's a great position to have a guy like Lossman who was ready to come back healthy for the first time this week.
J.P. Lossman, first round pick in 2004, 22nd overall out of Tulane. Second and 10 at the 46. Marshawn Lynch, burst of speed, lowers his shoulder. And gets close to the 40. Kenyon Coleman with the tackle, a gain of three. Have they given up on J.P. Lossman in Buffalo?
No, but they're very high on Trent Edwards. I think that's the difference. Edwards has really been a spark. He's done some things they really like. They like his intangibles, his communication skills. And he's given, and they've little by little, they've given Edwards more and more to handle. And he's handled it, everything they've given him, with flying colors. And that's why they're ready to give him a chance.
Golden opportunity, though, for Lossman to turn heads once again. Third and seven at the 43. Fred Jackson checks in. J.P. out of the gun. Here comes a blitz. Lossman fires it down the field. Parrish complete inside the five.
That's why J.P. Losman is a starter. He has got an arm for the deep ball. This is into the wind. The stutter and go by Parrish. And he had it in his hands and dropped it. And that's a pass you want your guy to catch. Losman takes a big shot in the pocket, but the ball was on the money.
So Mormont will punt it away. Fifth straight punt. And he gets off a beauty over the head of Washington. And he kicked that one out of the back of the end zone. A 50-yard punt, but only a net of 30 yards. Now, Thursday on Survivor China. Powerhouse Survivor James has an immunity idol. Could he find another? And don't miss a truly unique immunity challenge on a new episode of Survivor China, Thursday at 8, 7 Central on CBS. 106 remaining in the third quarter. Gus Johnson, Steve Tasker with you. From the Meadowlands, here comes Trent Edwards back onto the field.
We'll keep an eye on him. If he's going to come back in, he'll come over and start throwing the football on the sidelines. And if he does that, you can bet he'll be back in the game.
First down and 10 at the 20. You'll wonder if it's time for Eric Mangini to give his backup quarterback a chance, Kellen Clemens. Here's Jones hopping, and he dives forward, gets to the 22. John DeGiorgio with the tackle.
And another first down run to Jones, but there's the guy, Kellen Clemens, who people have been clamoring for here in New York. This guy does have a big arm. We'll have to wait and see whether he's got all the intangibles and the leadership that Chad Pennington has displayed throughout his career.
Second down and 8 at the 22. Jones again. Looking. And Jones now. Gets to the 28, maybe the 29 on the play. Terrific looking run. Kyle Williams gets him. A gain of 7.
You're right, Gus. That is a terrific run to end the quarter.
And that's the end of the third quarter with the score. The Bills 3, the Jets 3. We'll return to the Meadowlands after this message and a word from your local station.
It's been a wild ride for the Tigers and the Crimson Tide. LSU and Alabama continue the battle to be the best in the SEC West. Next Saturday on CBS.
The new season of The Amazing Race premieres CBS next Sunday after 60 Minutes.
They use it to shoot the game. They use it to broadcast the game. They use it to produce the game.
The main man on the field today is Peyton Manning.
So why wouldn't you use it to watch the game?
That's Peyton Manning.
Nice, Tony. Scoot over a bit, will you?
Nothing compares to a Sony Bravia HD TV because high definition is in our DNA.
Anybody got any chips?
Introducing the DirecTV Rewards Visa, the credit card that gives you once-in-a-lifetime rewards money can't buy. Turn your ordinary purchases into extraordinary rewards. Imagine talking sports with your favorite athlete, dancing with celebrities at Hollywood parties, or taking your own walk on the red carpet. Earn points with every purchase. Redeem them for once-in-a-lifetime rewards. The DirecTV Rewards Visa, the credit card that gives you rewards money can't buy.
Hockey's newest stars are busting the game wide open. NHL Center Ice on DirecTV. Follow your favorite team no matter where you live. Get up to 40 games a week from around the league, plus select games in crystal clear HD. Just 4 payments of $42.25. Break away now. Order NHL Center Ice and never miss a moment. Visit DirecTV.com or call 1-800-GET-SPORTS today.
At the beginning of our telecast, we told you that the story of this game, the quarterbacks. Buffalo on the right electing to go with a rookie, Edwards, who could be done for the day with that right wrist taped up. The Jets electing to stay with their veteran, Chad Pennington, and he's been mediocre at best this afternoon. Handing it off, Jones diving forward on third and one, I don't know.
but they're not going to give it to him. And that's a huge stop by the Bills' defensive line. They got penetration. Jones tried to go over the top and couldn't get there. And the Jets continue to sputter offensively. Although they did one thing right, Gus. They gave it to Thomas Jones.
And now the Jets will punt it away. Fourth straight punt for the Jets. End over end. Parrish fields it on the run at the 30. Roscoe looking, picking his way up, and he gets to the 40-yard line. A 42-yard punt and an 11-yard return.
When you bring up a good point about the quarterbacks, Gus, that this game really has been about it. J.P. Losman's going to stay in the game for the Buffalo Bills, which is a dramatic turn because he lost his job because of an injury. And now Trent Edwards, with the ice on his throwing arm, is not going to come back today. It doesn't look like. And Chad Pennington has struggled in this game. Has not thrown the ball well. He started out 5 of 5, and it has gone downhill from there. Neither offense has looked impressive at all.
Pennington, 10 of 16, 74 yards. First down at the 41. Marshawn Lynch, the deep man, in the eye. They give it to him. Lynch with great running room, and he gets to midfield. David Harris with the tackle, but it's a gain of 9 yards.
Yeah, the Bills ran weak over the left side. And they put extra blockers to the right, drew the defense, an extra defender over to the right side of the offense, and then ran back behind the huge left side of their offensive line. You see there Marshawn Lynch limping off a little bit. That hip may be starting to tighten up a little bit.
Both rookies banged up, Lynch and Edwards. Lynch, 14 carries, 53 yards. Second and one at midfield. Reed in motion, Dwayne Wright. The deep man, second man through is Wright, and he picks up a first down. A gain of 4, Hobson with the tackle.
When you talk about the fourth quarter, they've been outscored 75-35 in the fourth quarter this season. And that's not the only reason, but certainly when you're 1-6, that's one of the reasons.
Make that 73. Chad Pennington, that's okay, on the sideline. First down and 10. Buffalo at the 46. Lynch back in the game. Losman, the pass with time, throws a dart, and that one's caught. Evans inside the 30. Now that's one thing, 19-yard pickup. J.P. Losman could put some mustard on that football.
Man, this was a fastball. Lee Evans, one of the guys who actually came out and said he liked J.P. as the starting quarterback when there was a question of whether which guy it was going to be. And that's kind of the reason. J.P. Losman can throw the football any point on the field from any point on the field.
First down and 10 at the 27. Losman in for Edwards, providing a spark on this drive. Marshawn Lynch breaks it back, keeps his feet chopping, falls forward as usual at the 21. Hobson with the tackle, and it's a gain of 6.
And you know, you always say, Gus, they always fall forward, and it sounds like a little thing, but falling forward for an NFL player, that's the difference between a 2nd and 6 and a 2nd and 4. And it always makes a difference. And they say this game's a game of inches. You can't imagine how many games have been decided by the difference in the length of a football.
Second down and 4 at the 21. Schumann, Lynch in the eye. Reed in motion. Here's the rookie. And he'll get inside the 20. Harris, first man to it.
The Bills have Marshawn Lynch, and I'm telling you, if the Jets would watch the Bills' offense, Thomas Jones would have more carries. This is exactly the kind of thing the Jets refused to do with Thomas Jones in the first half and early in the second half. They had a running game like this one going, and they got away from it. That guy right there was killing the Buffalo Bills, and now he can't get back on the field.
So third down and 1 at the 18. Schumann and Lynch line up in the offset eye. J.P. Losman in for Trent Edwards. And they hand it off to Marshawn Lynch. And he's bottled up. Taken down. Elam. What a play by the second-year man out of Kent. A loss of 4.
And that's the first mistake I've seen Marshawn Lynch make with the ball in his hand? He cut this play to the outside. It should go right up inside that guy right there, and he cuts it outside. He should have gone inside the block of Schumann, and he goes outside of it, and that's the reason he got thrown for the loss. That play was inside, not outside, and Lynch made the mistake.
So that brings on Ryan Lindell, good from 30 yards. This one from 40 for the lead. They get it down, it's up, and good. Buffalo takes a 6-3 lead, 10:06 to play in the fourth.
At GMC, we've been breaking down barriers for over 100 years to create the all-new 2007 Sierra Denali, the most powerful half-ton V8 ever. In the all-new 2007 Sierra Heavy Duty, the most powerful one-ton ever. Part of the most extensive line of new pickups available. That's progress. That's professional grade.
We must stop inflation.
Senator, how is that achievable?
More than just fries. I can choose whatever celebrity's nose I want, but I have to have fries with my combo. What about a baked potato? Chili, a side salad, more than just fries. This is America, people.
He's making more sense than the governor.
At Wendy's, you can have more than just fries with your combo, like a side salad, baked potato, or even chili at no extra cost.
That's right.
Conquered the skies. Conquered Mount Everest. Conquered the moon. Conquered the neck. Introducing the new Philips Norelco Architect. The first Philips Norelco shaver with a flexible head which allows it to pivot and rotate freely, so you can easily get a close shave even on the neck. Simplicity is making hard-to-reach places easy to reach.
Tomorrow, one woman's dark secret will be revealed.
When I feel down about something, I shop. Whee!
Then...
Put him down!
A Homo habilis discovering his opposable thumb says what?
What?
A new Big Bang Theory after a new How I Met Your Mother. CBS tomorrow.
Some have been calling for change in New York. Pennington, the veteran, Clemens, second-year man out of Oregon, had a solid game against the Baltimore Ravens this year. 19 of 37, 260 yards, a touchdown, two interceptions. He has a strong arm. Chad Pennington will get an opportunity to go back into the game. His team down 6-3. Leon Washington back deep. And Washington will bring it up. Washington with the seam. And he's drilled at the 24-yard line. Nice looking tackle by Josh Stamer. Here comes Chad. Do or die. Down 6-3.
Oh, nice place.
I'll get us some Bud Lights. I'll take the stairs. I forgot the glasses.
That's pretty funny.
Not bad. Watch this. I'll take the escalator.
Refreshingly smooth Bud Light. Always worth it.
I'll go down and get dinner.
That is your house, Mama.
From Ridley Scott, the director of Gladiator and Black Hawk Down.
Who we want is Frank Lucas.
And Academy Award-winning producer Brian Grazer.
We're family, so we can't never forget where we came from.
Academy Award winners Denzel Washington and Russell Crowe. Based on a story as powerful as it is true. American Gangster. Rated R. Starts Friday.
Adam Sandler.
Yucky.
I now pronounce you Chuck and Larry. On DVD November 6th.
100 years of engineering breakthroughs. And now, a whole month of great savings. It's GMC Truck Month. Time for special deals on a huge selection of 07 models. But Truck Month only happens once a year. Don't wait another minute.
Get 0% APR for 60 months on most 07 GMC models. That's an average finance savings of $75.87 on Yukon. See their pros at your local GMC dealers.
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by Refreshingly Smooth Bud Light. Always worth it. American Gangster, starring Denzel Washington and Russell Crowe. And by GMC, official vehicle of the NFL and proud supporter of those who wanted more.
Jets with the football at their own 23, down 6-3. Chad Pennington under center. Cotterie in motion. Jones the single setback. Here's Pennington pumping, looking to the sideline, and it's caught. Nicely done. Cotterie steps out of bounds in front of Jabari Greer. A gain of 8 on the play.
Chad Pennington throwing the out route. Had lots of time to get that ball off, but that's going to be the mode of transportation. They've got to get the Bills defense to play honest so they can get Thomas Jones back involved. And you see there, he just does not throw the football down the field. 10 attempts under 15, only one over 15.
Lavernous Cole, no catches today. Jones fumbled it, and he covers it up. It's Jets have already lost a fumble today. Leon Washington.
He never had it. I mean, had his hands. Pennington put it in the right spot. You can't explain that. I mean, they've handed the ball off literally hundreds of times. So and they both did everything just right. It looked like it hit his arm on the way in.
So that makes it third down and 6 at the 28. They need to go to the 33 for a first down. Pennington in the shotgun. That's Cotterie in motion. Here's Pennington. Over the middle, and it's caught. Smith, great catch, first down Jets at the 40. George Wilson with the tackle. New England and Washington continuing to battle. Here's James Brown in New York.
Hey, Gus, the only battle? Well, I'm not sure. It's not a really, other than maybe to keep from getting 40 points. Take a look at this. Mike Vrabel, third sack of the game, third force fumble, picked up by Roosevelt Colvin, 11 yards of pay dirt, 38-0. Back to Gus and Steve.
New England looking terrific this season. First and 10 at the 39. Here's the play action fake. Pennington steps up, throws on the run, and it's caught on the sideline. Lavernous Cole dropped by Terrence McGee, and Coles is down. The first catch of the day for Lavernous Cole. Last week, 8 catches, 133, 2 touchdowns against Cincy.
And this was a great catch, but you watch the impact. And I don't think that ball, that's an incomplete pass, I'll bet you. If you want to review that, you probably could. But I don't think it was obviously not the hit that hurt him. I think it was the impact with the ground.
8:03 to play in the fourth quarter. Jets on the move. Back right after this.
In today's luxury game, the real question isn't whether or not your car has available features like a 304-horsepower engine. It's not a question of track-tuned suspensions, pop-up navs, 40-gig hard drives, or any of that. No. In today's luxury game, the real question is, when you turn your car on, does it return the favor?
Are you easily distracted? Avoiding others? Is it affecting your home life? You may be a numismatist, a collector of coins, but now there's a cure. Genuine United States Mint coins, like the Presidential $1 Coin Proof Set. These coin sets may cause euphoria, insomnia, and are extremely habit-forming. If you're a numismatist, now there's hope for you. Visit usmint.gov. United States Mint, genuinely worthwhile.
We've been to Portland, Monterey, Fresno on the way.
Panda's Monkeys at the Zoo taking home a kangaroo.
Comfort Inn feels like home. Morning, Lisa.
Morning, Joe.
Tasty waffles. Hey, look, finally something I can cook.
County Fair, Salt Lake, gotta love those funnel cakes.
Santa Fe, Grandma's Place, nice to see her smiling face.
This fall, stay at Comfort Inn, Comfort Suites, Quality, Sleep Inn, or Clarion Hotels. After 2 separate stays, you'll earn a free night with choice privileges. For reservations, visit choicehotels.com. Choice Hotels. We'll see you there.
On the night after Halloween, it's a CSI treat when an actress is axed. A new CSI then.
I'm sorry, I gotta sit down for a second.
I'm pregnant.
New Without a Trace after CSI, CBS Thursday.
Great sign for the Jets. Lavernous Cole's up on his feet, walking off on his own after taking a hard hit from Terrence McGee.
And that's one of the guys for the Jets that deserves his teammates' admiration, not for getting up from this hit, but the way he plays. This guy is a leader on that team. He comes to play every week. He's one of the best players on their club. He's a true professional, and I know Eric Mangini has the greatest amount of respect for him, and so do his teammates.
First catch of the day for Lavernous Coles.
They do not want to lose him for any length of time. And it looks like I would be surprised if he came back in after that. I mean, that took him a long time to climb to his feet.
So the Jets with the football now at the Buffalo 48-yard line. Chad Pennington, 3 of 3 on this drive, 32 yards. Out of the gun once again. They hand it off to Jones. And he spins and goes down at the 43. Larry Triplett, the former Indianapolis Colt, with the tackle at a 5-yard gain.
Yeah, and that sense of urgency that the Jets offense came out on this drive with is good, but they got to remember they got 7.5 minutes. A touchdown gives them the lead. A field goal ties it. There's no need to panic. Run their offense, keep Jones involved, and now with Leon Washington in there, keep the running game involved.
Second down at 5 at the 43. Washington. He stumbles, and Washington is taken down. John DiGiorgio, the middle linebacker, who's had a fine game with the tackle. Schobel also in on the play.
And this is a crucial third down for the Jets. With 6:40 to go, you don't know how long it's going to be before you get the football back the way the Bills were able to run it on their last drive.
Is this four down territory?
I think you might be thinking about it if you're Eric Mangini. Down in the Bills' end, I think you might give them two downs to make this.
Third down and 3 at the 41. Pennington waves over Kotchery. He's been great over the middle today. Pennington looking. Pennington over the middle and complete. Intended for Baker, and that'll bring up fourth down. And Eric Mangini is going to punt. With 6:09 to go.
Well, they had Pennington by the foot, and he doesn't really throw it so hard anyway, and he can't step into it. This play has no chance to get there. And of course, his Hargrove around his ankle.
So the Jets punt it away, end over end. Punt for Graham. And it takes a bounce and will be down. It dies at the 5 or inside the 5. Terrific job by Ben Graham. Buffalo will huddle up in their own end zone.
Coach. Hey, Coach! Those guys just took off with all your cold, refreshing Coors Light. Who do they think they are?
They are who we thought they were.
They are who you thought they were? Well, who do you think they were?
They are who we thought they were.
Okay. Well, if you knew who they were, why didn't you stop them?
We let them off the hook.
Frostbrew Coors Light, official beer sponsor of the NFL.
Coach, those guys that took your Coors Light, they went that way.
Those guys are toast.
Sweetie, got you this new phone with a full keyboard, because you're my number one.
Hey, honey, got you this great phone from Verizon Wireless, because you're my number one.
There you are. Got you this new phone with VCast,
because,
awesome. You know, you're my number one.
Saving the best for numero uno.
Get a great deal on these cool Samsung phones. Plus, join the Verizon Wireless Family Share Plan and add a line for $9.99. Verizon Wireless.
In today's luxury game, the question isn't whether or not your car has available features like a 40-gig hard drive. It isn't about sunroofs or Sapelli wood accents, pop-up nav screens, or any of that. No, the real question is, when you turn your car on, does it return the favor?
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by Verizon Wireless and by Cadillac, introducing the all-new 2008 Cadillac CTS.
Vote for the 2008 Pro Bowl at NFL.com/Pro Bowl or text PRO to 7777 via your Sprint service. Standard text messaging rates apply. And here's the handoff. Marshawn Lynch will give the Buffalo Bills running room as he gets it to the 10-yard line. It's all only at NFL.com as Elam makes the tackle. But that's a gain of 7.
Well, it's with 5:43 and counting in this game, the Bills want to run the football and not let Chad Pennington back on the field. And that, I think, at that point, yards per rush. The Jets are running the ball very well. But I think the Bills would love to run this clock out with 5 minutes to go. They have not been able to close out games like this. They've lost a lot of close games at the end. And I think today, with the running game, they may be able to do it.
Second down and 3. That time the Jets come up big. Rhodes in on the play, brings up third down and short for Buffalo. 5 minutes to play in
there,
the
you
fourth.
Say, in both these games, Denver and Dallas lost on the final play from scrimmage by a field goal. And you got to run the football here. You don't want to throw it, because the worst that can happen is if you turn it over.
Third down and 1 at the 12. Lynch, the deep man. Here's Marshawn Lynch. Leans forward, picks up the first down as he gets to the 15 and gains 3 yards.
A little bit of a hesitation on the handoff. Watch as he comes through. Looks like he doesn't get a clean handle on it. But this is why you draft a guy in the first round. He had a good handle on it. A guy that can get yards like that. At the end of a game, when they know you're going to run it, you know you're going to run it, you hand it off to the only guy you've been handing it off to all day, and he can make it happen.
Marshawn Lynch, 20 carries, 70 yards. First down. Lastman will throw on first down. Firing down the field. Dangerous.
His number one guy comes through for him. He let Lee Evans try and make a play, and Evans just wrestled the football away from the defender and really put this game away. You'll see him coming down, and the ball's going to be there. They both go up for it. Well played. It's well played by Revis, but Evans, the veteran, just has the stronger grip on it and makes the play.
J.P. Lossman comes in off the bench for Trent Edwards. Provides the spark this team needed. Extra point up and good. 3:38 to play in the fourth. Lee Evans, throw it to your best player. Let him make a play. Lee Evans does.
Kenny, I need 50 pounds of roast beef.
Sorry, Pat. We're all out.
Oh, don't give me that.
What, did your wife wolf it down for breakfast? That came out wrong. Look, she's not, look at me. I mean, we probably weigh this.
The network you can trust, AT&T. Now buy our new Nokia and get one free.
Make some room. Do
DirecTV, the leader in satellite television, is now pumping out over 70 of the best national channels in HD. And up to 100 by the end of the year. That's crazy big. So much high def it blows cable and Dish Network away. Get yours today.
Help victims of the California fires and thousands of disasters in the U.S. each year. Call 800-HELP-NOW or visit redcross.org today. Wow, there are going to be a lot of questions this week. How about J.P. Lossman coming in off the bench and throwing a home run pass to Lee Evans? 85 yards to give Buffalo a 13-3 lead on the other sideline. Eric Mangini, he didn't go for it on fourth down. They'll question him all week about it.
Well, you got to think, too, that the Jets' defense has been, well, we showed the graphic. They're in the bottom five in the league in every statistical category you can think of, and Eric Mangini is asking them to go down and stop the Bills' offense and win the game. I think you give them two plays to make the third and three and keep them on the field and give your offense a chance to do it.
Leon Washington back deep. He'll get an opportunity. The best in the NFL. They need him right now. And Washington is wrapped up at the 20 and drilled backwards. Great special teams play by Buffalo. Coming up, time permitting, after the game, the Subway postgame show. Join JB, Dan, Shannon, Boomer, and Coach C for all the latest NFL scores and highlights. That's all coming up on the Subway postgame show.
And there he is.
Chad Pennington on the sideline. He has been benched. They bring Kellen Clemens into the game. Eric Mangini needs a spark right now, but did he wait too late? 3:32 to go.
Well, like you said, Gus, the last possession was the key possession, I think, for him. Now with 3:30, you're in full desperation mode, and you've got your backup in now, hoping for a spark.
He does have a strong arm. Here's Clemens over the middle, incomplete. That one intended for Cotchery. Chad Pennington.
Well, 3 points is not enough. 87 yards in the air today. It was a windy day. 87 yards through the air. You can't put that one on your defense. You can't put that on your defense.
Now you have to wonder, is this the end for Chad Pennington? Second and 10 at the 20. Clemens, and he's dropped. No, he stays on his feet and almost turned it over.
Yeah, that was a
Buffalo bringing everybody.
And they got there. Clemens doing a nice job. Watch, he's going to let this rush go right over his back. They come free. That's Crowell goes right over the top. He moves almost like a judo thing. And then he tries to flip it forward to Washington. Almost goes right into the arms of Joe.
So that brings up third down and 10 at the 20-yard line.
No, that's to Giorgio.
Here's Clemens in the shotgun. Clemens steps up, throws over the... Whoa! Complete at the 35. This kid can throw the ball.
Oh, man, that was a dart. He flicked it from the back of his right ear. He hangs in the pocket, exactly what you want to see. And oof.
First down.
Nice throw.
At the 38. Here comes a blitz. Over the middle. Baker with the catch. He gets to midfield. 250 and counting. Hargrove with the tackle. Gain of 11.
I'll tell you what, it's not over yet, but I'll tell you what, you want to talk about heat. The heat is really going to be turned up this week on Chad Pennington and Eric Mangini.
First down at the 49. Clemens. Underneath, incomplete. And he put a whole lot on that one. Baker just couldn't hold on. Crowell defensively. 2:33 to go. The Jets have three timeouts and the two-minute warning, so a lot of time remaining for Eric Mangini's squad.
They need a field goal and a touchdown to tie it up. And there's plenty of time to do that if you can get the ball back, if you score.
Second down and 10 at the 49. Clemens, pump fake. goes up top, picked off, McGee. And that may do it. Terrence McGee picks it off. And Buffalo has it once again with 2:27 to go in the fourth.
And I'll tell you what, after this play, and this is a young quarterback trying to make a play, obviously. But I'll tell you what, if I'm Eric Mangini, I don't know who you play next week. Because that's exactly the kind of thing that a young quarterback is going to do. This is a team that's not good enough to overcome those type of mistakes. And but then by the same token, Chad Pennington has done the same thing in the fourth quarter all year.
So Buffalo takes over at the 33-yard line. J.P. Losman with the maybe the offensive player of the year for this Buffalo Bills squad. Buffalo next week will be at home to take on Cincinnati. Then they travel to Miami on the 11th. For the New York Jets, it doesn't get any easier. They'll take on Washington next week.
Oh, I have the worst cold.
Here, take some NyQuil. It'll relieve your symptoms to help you sleep.
Huh?
Yeah, you'll sleep like a bit. You'll sleep like a lay. Like. Sleep like you did before the rooster went blind.
NyQuil.
I'll take that.
The nighttime sniffling, sneezing, coughing, aching, fever, best sleep you ever got with a cold, medicine. For daytime symptoms, try DayQuil.
Coming up, time permitting, after the game, the Subway postgame show. Join JB, Dan, Shannon, Boomer, and Coach Cowher for all the latest NFL scores and highlights. That's all coming up on the Subway postgame show. Second down and 8 at the 35. Marshawn Lynch still turning his legs, and he gets to the 45-yard line and picks up a first down, a gain of 10.
And this is exactly what the Bills want to do. First downs are going to win the game for them.
And that should take us to the 2-minute warning with the score. Buffalo 13, the Jets 3.
Your entire business could learn to minimize risks. Well, off the course anyway, because change happens. Zurich.
Okay, the presentation's tomorrow, so let's make sure we all know our usual responsibilities. Jeff, you keep feeding me old information. Dean, I need you to continue not living up to your resume. Sue, you're in charge of waffling.
Are you sure?
Jerome, you'll talk a big game, then do nothing.
Let's do it.
Rick, can you fold under pressure for me?
Like a lawn chair.
And Ted, you just keep thinking everyone's out to get you.
They are.
I'll be at FedEx Kinko's, where they'll help me design, print, copy, and finish the proposal.
Put your presentations together at FedEx Kinko's, where color copies are now just 49 cents. Our office is your office.
Don't just watch it, live it. Experience the ultimate in high definition with LG Full HD. LG, life's good.
Touchdown Seahawks!
NFL players love to watch themselves, only at the all-new NFL.com.
Did you see that?
Offense. We're going to use our body and knock them out of the way.
Defense.
Don't get married to other girls!
The Amazing Race premieres CBS next Sunday.
Chad Pennington watching from the sideline, benched in the fourth quarter. And Buffalo running the football right on first down. Picks up 6 yards on the play. Hank Poteet with the tackle. Let's go back to 97. The last time the Bills swept the Jets in a season was back in 97. Our own Steve Tasker getting blown up.
Ow!
Jay Riemersma, his touchdown sealed the win in the first game. And in the second game, Todd Collins hit Lonnie Johnson on a 62-yard touchdown pass. Steve Tasker retired after the season, and the Bills haven't swept the Jets since.
Should have retired after that hit.
But J.P. Lossman, how about this man coming in for Trent Edwards, who injured his wrist on his throwing hand. Lossman losing his job to Edwards, but comes in today and makes a terrific play.
And I don't think you take anything away from Trent Edwards. I still think you come out of here, if he's able, I still think Trent Edwards will probably start next week for the Buffalo Bills. I don't know if you're going to have the same starter for the New York Jets.
Here's the handoff right. So if you're Eric Mangini, who do you start next week against Washington?
Well, first let me say, I like Chad Pennington. He's a good quarterback. I like him, I like the way he plays, but I think at this point you're 1-7, you make the change. Clemens is a thing you need to make a spark, and I think you do it in your post-game interviews right after this game. I don't even wait till tomorrow. It takes a lot of pressure, and it takes your players, the rest of your players in the team, gives them something to focus on other than the problems they had today.
Don't forget, next Sunday, the NFL on CBS goes for two as LT and the Chargers take on Adrian Peterson and the Vikes, or the Jags tangle with the Saints. And in the nightcap, folks, this is the one we've all been waiting to see. Tom Brady leads the Pats against Peyton Manning and the Colts. Two undefeated teams. Check local listings, beginning with JB, Dan, Shannon, Boomer, and Coach C on the NFL Today. That one will be one to watch. Third down, 3. They hand it off. And Wright goes backwards. So Buffalo will punt it away. Sean Ellison on the play. But you wonder if Eric Mangini is even second-guessing himself, if he's saying, maybe I should have gone for it.
I'll tell you.
On fourth down.
Yeah, maybe so. But I don't think it was. I can't second-guess him about starting Chad Pennington today. I thought that was the right move, given last week's 31-point outbreak against Cincinnati. I thought it was the right move, but I don't think it is this week. I think you make the change.
So Washington back deep at the 10-yard line, 1-12 and counting. Jets are out of timeouts. Mormon taking his time, and he'll take the penalty.
And they took a timeout. Yeah, the Bills will take a quick timeout to let all the time run out and then not take the penalty.
Tomorrow on CBS, when the sky goes dark and the wolves begin to howl, it must be Halloween in Miami. David Caruso stars in the most frightening episode yet, a new CSI Miami tomorrow at 10, 9 Central on CBS. Let's turn our attention now to the Buffalo Bills. They lose two close games on the final play of the game, one to Denver, the other to Dallas. Since then, though, they've been playing some excellent football. As you take a look, Buffalo will win this game. Coming in, they had won two of their last three.
Yeah, and this stretch, this game, and then these two, it feel like they might be able to get on a little run. Cincinnati and Miami coming in. Cincinnati struggling very badly on defense. And, of course, Miami struggling in just about every facet of their game.
Cincinnati beaten today by Pittsburgh. This ball will be downed at the 25. Dick Geron, a very quiet man, a reserved man, but he has this team focused, and he has this team playing very well as the unit. And one thing you can say about him is, finally, they're getting healthy.
They are getting healthy, and they've got the kind of players now that are going to play up to their potential. I mean, I think they've had two very good drafts in the last 2 years. Dick Geron is the kind of coach that's going to keep this team focused. I think there's a lot of people, and rightfully so, gave the coaching staff a little trouble when they lost that Dallas Monday night game with some of the things that happened at the end of that game. But no question, this team is playing much, much better football than it was just a month ago.
Clemens remains in at quarterback. Under a minute to go. Dumps it off. Washington trying to get to the sideline, and he does. And he stops the clock with 48 seconds left. 11-yard pickup.
Yeah, right.
And you know, already, and it's late in the game, and it always looks like this when the backup quarterback comes in a game that seems lost. The defense plays differently. They're looser. The receivers are more open. It makes the quarterback look that much better. And it seems as though the critics of Chad Pennington can crow all they want about how good Clemens looks at the end of this game. But nevertheless, I think it's right. I think it's time for the change to come in New York.
Here's Clemens hitting as he throws it. It's scooped up off the ground by Kotchery. He spins and gets to the 44. Terrence McGee with the tackle. Clock continues to run. 7-yard gain. Jets quickly up to the line of scrimmage. Here's Clemens. Underneath, Smith with the grab. He gets to the 40, goes down. 20 seconds of counting. 19-yard gain. Whitner with the tackle. Jets have to hurry up. And he spikes it.
You know, you think about this Jet team and what they're going through. They were a playoff team a year ago. And you think of the Chicago Bears of being in the Super Bowl. They made a quarterback change this year as well because their starter, Rex Grossman, was not playing well. Their offense was sputtering. And I think now you can make that analogy that the Jets are in the same situation.
Chicago losing to Detroit today, 16-7. 9 seconds left. Here's Clemens. Bills in the prevent. Clemens with the strong arm will throw it all the way down the field. And it is incomplete, out of bounds with 1 second left. Wilson trying to hang off with the interception. So the Buffalo Bills will sweep the New York Jets for the first time since 1997. Dick Geron, and the Buffalo Bills improved their record to 3-4. The Jets lose their fifth straight, falling to 1-7.
A playoff team a year ago for Eric Mangini, and now nothing to look forward to except trying to build on what they can do positive in each game.
Here's Clemens, fires it down the field, and it's intercepted. And that'll do it. The final score from the Meadowlands. Buffalo defeats the New York Jets 13-3. Chad Pennington, it may be over for him. J.P. Lossman off the bench. The hero throws a big time pass to his favorite target, Lee Evans, 85 yards. So for Steve Tasker, this is Gus Johnson saying so long from the Meadowlands. You've been watching the National Football League on CBS. We'll go to the Subway postgame show after this.
Now, see, when people think of Geico, right, they think of car insurance. And, of course, saving money. But sometimes that can lead even the savviest driver astray. Take, for example, the motorcycle owner. He calls Geico wanting to save money on his car insurance, only to realise that he doesn't actually own a car. Well, needless to say, he's quite embarrassed, isn't he? Doesn't matter. Geico insures motorcycles and ATVs as well. That way, no one ends up looking foolish.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
And now, here's the Geico play of the day. The Colts remained unbeaten as Peyton Manning found Reggie Wayne on this 59-yard touchdown in their 31-7 win over the Panthers. This toss was the 288th career TD pass for Manning, surpassing Johnny Unitas for first place in Colts franchise history. Brought to you by Geico. 15 minutes can save you 15% or more on car insurance.
If you think there's no big news in battery technology, consider this. Now you can take up to 5,000 pictures over the life of two batteries. New Duracell rechargeables. They're rechargeables reinvented. Duracell, trusted everywhere.
It's endless shrimp. The only time of year to enjoy all the irresistible shrimp you can eat. All of your favorites are back, plus new buffalo shrimp. It's endless shrimp for a short time at Red Lobster. Come see what's fresh today.
Next Sunday, the NFL on CBS features the super matchup of the year. The unbeaten Patriots versus the undefeated Colts. And your ticket to the game starts on the NFL Today at 12 noon. The Subway Postgame Show is sponsored by Subway Restaurants. It's where to eat when you want to eat fresh. Subway, eat fresh.
And welcome back to our New York studios and the Subway Postgame Show. I'm James Brown. Tonight on CBS, it's another edition of 60 Minutes. You'll meet the new president of France. He loves Americans, but stormed out of his interview with Leslie Stahl. Find out why tonight on 60 Minutes. That's followed by CSI on a special night, and then all new episodes of Cold Case and Shark. It's all coming up tonight on CBS, America's most watched network. And a reminder that we'll be back next Sunday at noon Eastern with another edition of the NFL Today, followed by Week 9 doubleheader action here on CBS. Among the early starts, the Chargers and the Vikings, the Jaguars taking on the Saints, and the Bengals doing battle with the Bills. In our second game, most of you will see the highly anticipated rematch. Shannon worded it best. The big boys held serve. New England and the Colts. A rematch of the AFC Championship game. For others, it's the Texans taking on the Raiders. And it all starts noon Eastern with the NFL Today. Back here with my guys, Dan, Coach, Shannon, and Boomer. Score Jets. Wow, lose it 13-3. Boomer, what gives?
Well, I'll tell you what's going to give. There's going to be a new quarterback for the New York Jets. I would be surprised if Kellen Clemens does not start from this point on. I have to tell you, I've been in Chad Pennington's shoes in the Meadowlands, played for a team that went 3-13 under Rich Kotite his first year as a New York Jet. There's nothing more humiliating than standing on that sideline listening to those Jets fans, you know, serenade the team with boos. And you know, I know exactly what Chad feels like. I think it's over with now. Now they got to figure out whether or not this young kid, Kellen Clemens, is a player that they can count on for the future. You just got, especially the next week, being a home game against the Washington Redskins, you know, just get Chad off the field and let's see if the young kid could do it now.
Wow.
And this is a game that Buffalo, they had to beat. They had to beat the Buffalo Bills. They didn't do it. And I agree with you. I think you got to make the change now to spark the team.
Anything to save the whatever you have left.
It's over.
All right, let's talk about a little highlights here. Skins and Patriots. Bill.
Well, I mean, where are you going to start? Here's Tom Brady, 3 touchdown passes again, 8th straight game, NFL record. He runs for 2 more. But how about the day Mike Vrabel has? He's going to get a sack here, 3 sacks, 3 caused fumbles, 11 tackles, and he catches a touchdown pass. This team is playing very, very well heading into next week against the
Cardinals. That's an understatement.
Wow, and Shannon, what did you say earlier that the Texans would make that the Patriots would do what? Skip 30?
They skipped 30, went straight to 45. Don't worry about it, Coach.
All right, Shannon.
Let's hope Arnold Schwarzenegger is a better politician than he is a coin flipper, because he did a horrible job with that. Matt Turk fall on it.
Oh.
Antonio Cromartie does. Touchdown, Charger. Antonio Gates, 31 yards, his second touchdown of the day. Ooh, JB, San Diego was rolling. Obviously, being going to Arizona, being displaced for momentarily, had no effects on these guys. They came ready to play.
Chargers have found a groove. Dan!
And you have Jeff Garcia, a little play-action pass. Aaron Glenn sits on it outside on Joey Galloway. He returns it 28 yards for a touchdown. But Jeff Garcia comes back. He's looking for Joey Galloway again. On the day, he was 15 for 28, 214 yards, 2 touchdowns. This one here, 58 yards to Joey Galloway. And then there's another pass, a second touchdown from Garcia to Michael Bennett. He goes in 19 yards. That puts Tampa Bay up right then. Then Quinn Gray comes back. Little touch pass fade. Nice catch. One-hander Matt Jones. 8-yarder. Here you go. Jacksonville up by 1.
Quinn Gray making his first NFL start at quarterback. Jags first trip to Tampa Bay since 1995. Saints and Niners.
Well, God, NFC. Here come the Saints. Here comes Drew Brees. 26 of 33. 3 touchdowns. 2 of them you're going to see to Marquise Colston. There's one there. Also finds Terrence Carter in the end zone for a touchdown. But the San Francisco 49ers, they can't do anything. Here's a pass right here. You're going to see to Terrence Carter with the Marquise Colston. San Francisco, 155 yards of total offense, 24-3. With 8:54 to go, I'm telling you right now, New Orleans is playing well.
That's a pure game. Pure game, baby.
All right, Shannon.
Andy Peyton Manning, they're up 17-7. He's looking for his favorite guy, Reggie Wayne. 7 catches,
nice.
168.
In the bucket.
And a touchdown. Puts him up 24-7. Joseph Addai had 23 carries, 100 yards, and 2 touchdown rushing, and 1 receiving. 31-7. Andy Hale, sir, we ready. We ready. We ready. They ready for New England.
And Manning's also ready, having surpassed Johnny Unitas' career all-time touchdown leader for the franchise.
And Sebastian Janikowski hits this 50-yarder, becoming the Raiders' all-time leader in field goals made. But the Tennessee Titans are a physical football team. They ran the ball all day. Chris Henry, 24 yards for a score here. Tennessee had 192 yards rushing. Dante Culpepper tried to bring it back. Mike Williams dropped it on fourth down. Game over.
Titans have now won 10 of the last 13 as they win this one over the Raiders. Steelers and Bengals coach.
Big game down in Cincinnati, but it was all Ben Roethlisberger and the Steelers on their offense. He's going to find Hines Ward here in the end zone, beating Leon Hall for a touchdown. He threw two of them on the day, both to Hines Ward. And Willie Parker went over 100 yards again, 126 on the day. The defense held him to 13 yards, 24-13. Big Pittsburgh win. Puts him up 5-2 and up three games on Cincinnati.
All righty, so let's keep on going with the scoreboard here. The Cleveland Browns improved to 4-3. Derek Anderson, three touchdown tosses in that victory there. The Giants over in London, a sloppy affair, but the Giants win it. Eagles upending the Vikings 23-16 there. Westbrook, a big game. And the Lions on the road, knocking off the Bears. And we'd like to welcome those of you who have watched the San Diego Chargers knock off the Houston Texans 35-10. The Chargers getting their groove on now, improving to 4-3 with that victory. Next week, folks, the Titanic, big matchup. The big boys, to coin Shannon's expression, have held serve New England and Indianapolis undefeated. They will meet next week. It will be a rematch of the AFC Championship game. Your thoughts, Boomer?
Super Bowl 41.5. I like the New England Patriots. They are unstoppable. Best offense the NFL has ever seen.
Two heavyweights knocking head. This is what we wanted. They both held serves. We got the matchup for the century. Not in a non-Super Bowl game. Right here, New England, Indy.
These two teams are playing at a different level than everybody else in the National Football League. And, you know, they're playing each other next week. You can't get any better than that for the midway point of the season.
And Peyton Manning's going to have to play keep away from Tom Brady, believe it or not. Everybody plays keep away from Peyton Manning, but they're going to have to run the football, be good on third downs, and keep that offense off the field.
Coach was right, JB. They were not going to score 30 points today. They were going to score 52.
and there's still time left on the clock in that game. Tonight on CBS begins with another edition of 60 Minutes. That's followed by CSI on a special night, and then all new episodes of Cold Case and Shark. So, for Boomer Esiason, Shannon Sharp, Coach Bill Cowher, Dan Marino, I'm James Brown. We'll see you next week. Titanic matchup right here on CBS.
What can SwabBiz do for your bottom line? With no setup or transaction fees, Southwest Airlines' free online corporate travel tool can save your business a bundle. To sign up, visit swabiz.com.
You are now free to move about the country.
CBS Sports thanks you for watching this presentation of the National Football League.
Rules of Engagement, tomorrow on CBS.
Enjoy the most college hoops in the nation on ESPN Full Court from DirecTV. With key matchups from some of college basketball's top conferences, ESPN Full Court takes it to the hoop with up to 30 games per week from outside your local area. Special early bird offer, only two payments of $49.50 each. Order by November 23rd and save $10 off the regular price. Call 1-800-GET-SPORTS or log on to DirecTV.com/Full Court. ESPN Full Court from DirecTV.
Sunday, live Sunday, October 28th on DirecTV pay-per-view.
took my hand, you showed me how. You promised me you'd be around. Uh-huh, that's right. I took your words and I believed in everything you said to me. Yeah, that's right.
Until